Holy Fifi, Holy Fifi, Habe Hose Baga Nzamayi Se Haole De Haole De Hagi Batle Tsebo Yanto Tsohle Wena Ondikani.
Good morning, everyone. The time was slightly behind. We're 20 minutes behind now. So I think let's do start with our program. My name is Sivuile Paliso, and I'll be your co-MC with Ubuhle Manichana. Amen. I must just state it as we start that Utsidis was a very fun person, and I know we're here because we want to mourn him. But I think throughout the program, we must just adjust a bit and show him a bit of a vibe because of the person he was, right? I know you all want to cry. We've been crying throughout. So we are starting this program, except for one clown who is missing among us. He would call us clowns. By the way, all of you here, I'm sure you know that by now, that you are probably a clown to him. He would say, "My chief, you are so poor. You are a clown, my chief." And we'll start this session today missing that just that one important clown, which is Tsidiso Mofokeng, a man who is dearly loved, we appreciated, a good brother, a good friend. It's really unbelievable that we are standing here without him in our presence. But we do know that his spirit is among us, and therefore let me take this moment just to welcome you all and say, yes, it has happened. We do want to celebrate him. While we are mourning him, we must celebrate the person he was, a great friend, a great brother, great colleague, employer, and so forth. So I'll be co-emceeing with Buhle. I'll hand over to him now. Thank you.
Thank you, Sivu. I think, first and foremost, the reason why Sivu asked me to stand here with him is because he said he can't do it alone. I think we all have heavy hearts, but the essence of today is to celebrate his life. I think if we miss that part, then we miss the essence of today. Cry if you must, but I think if we can manage to make you walk out of here with a smile and just a reflection of seeing his smile, then we've done something right. We don't promise. We too might cry, so bear with us. But we soldier on anyway. Thank you, Sivu, for the warm welcome. If we can jump into the program, I think everybody's got the QR code. If you don't, there is a bit of, I don't want to say a leaflet, but a flyer with his smile again on it. Zocela umama, Pastor Matlodi, to please come and just to open for us with a word of prayer. Thank you, ba.
Moyo wangu yakudinga wena msindisi wami hlala nami hlala nami lisho nelilanga
Tate kima ya kawena utswane tswi kitoriso tate kima tate kima tate ya ka Kawena utswane utshwanetswe ke toriso ntate ke mang ntate ke mang ntate ya ka ka we na utshwanetswe utshwanetswe ke toriso tate ke mang ya kanka wena wena o khosi ya dikhosi modimo wa rona le moshong wa letsatsi modimo wena o santse o le modimo wena o modimo wa maemo wa tle Jehova mabali wa matshelo a rona le siemo se re le mo go sona right now wena modimo o santse o le modimo wena o modimo ha o fetoge ha o tshwane le motho mabali wa matshelo a rona Jehova re tla dula re go boka re go tlotlisa maemo ngotlhe a bophelo le botlhoko bo re le mo go bona right now modimo wa rona re tla go boka re go tlotlise wena o tshwanetswe ke dipoko ka dinako tsotlhe modimo wa rona ke ka mo re bua mantsu a re mo mmina thokong ya kang ka wena ke mang ha ayo modimo wa rona wena you will remain God even le ha maemo a sa dumele Jehova ke wa mosho kana motshegare wa letsatsi la gompieno modimo re kopane re le phuthego re le di family modimo re le ditsala le di colleagues modimo wa rona re tla matshidisong a ngwana bo rona e leng tshidiso Godfrey Mofokeng Modimo wa rona re kopa matla go tswa go wena re kopa kgalalelo ya gago. A nne wena modimo tlo etella ntsotlhe pele tsa letsatsi la gompieno tse di tlo go diragala mabali wa matshelo. A nne wena modimo o re etella pele give us strength modimo. E fa mongwe le mongwe Jehova o mo teng ga ntlo ya gago mo fe matla modimo botlhe ba ba utlwileng botlhoko Jehova. O ko ba sidile o ba bofe ka isopa ya gago modimo wa rona yo bophelo. Ke le losika lo ra Mofokeng moshong kana motshegare ngwa letsatsi modimo. Dipelo tsa bone di thubegile dikeledi di akeleketla marameng Jehova. Modimo wa rona o ko ba sidile dipelo tsa di utlwileng botlhoko. O ba phimile dikeledi modimo wa rona. Ba fe matla ntata mosamo hao. Ba sa bereka loso la ngwana bo bona Jehova. A nne wena ba pesang ka matla modimo wa rona. A nne wena ba tshwarang ka letsogo la gago le letona modimo. Re ba kopela matla modimo wa rona yo phelang. Re ba kopela tshireletso modimo wa rona yo phelang. Re ba kopela lerato le kagiso le mohau modimo. E re hantse ba tswella ka mmere kwa ngwana bona Jehova. Wena bo ba tshwere ka matla ga go ba tisitse modimo. Mabali wa matshelo a rona tiro ya simolla. E tle re ha e simolla Jehova re neela tsotlhe go wena. Speaker se sengwe le se sengwe se se tlileng go bua modimo. A se bue mantswe a nnete a phedisang a fodisa modimo. Gore losika lo ga Mofokeng e tle re ha letswa fa modimo. Le tle le tswe le fodile modimo ba na le tshepo ka wena o tshepo Jehova. Modimo wa rona re ya kopa re etelele pele. Re sireletse re boloke go tsotlhe tse di tla diragalang. Give each and everyone o tlo emang fa pele ga gago modimo. Umufemata Jehovah Hubua, who sirelets and its Ohola Hahumudimu, who bua said its honnets in Jehovah, Mudimarunabaita Lepil, Botlamudimu, who saw Koba Sadim, who Yakoba Nelu, stickily the colleagues Muruti, Liburuti, while it's at Silla Humpieno, I tell no one out Samay Santiro, Mudimakaba Sirelete, Oba Boloka Mudimu, Oba Femat Cities on Nita Sibili. Everyone not like a man for Pilmodimo, Mudimarunara Hubokara Hutotisa, Hunerunara Barrett Sepilenwena. We give all Mudim to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Dipilu di Robehile Limoya.
Guys, if you remember, we said we're here to celebrate. So I'd like us to run another one. And we all partake and we all sing. Part of celebrations is letting our hearts to be free. So ngicela nikhululeke. Be free, be comfortable. We're here to celebrate with CDs. We'd have wanted us to all celebrate and all smile and all laugh with this big laughter. So please join in. Let's all partake. Celuspinda mkhulu.
Jehovah Riahuboka Riahuboka Rinse Rita Jehovah Riahuboka 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 Riahuboka, 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 Jehovah Riahuboka
That's much better, guys. That's much better. We are in church after all, and praise and worship is an integral part of church. In keeping the spirit going, I think there's something that we overlooked, if I'm not mistaken. Some ground rules. I think we'll see if we maybe can guide us in terms of what we forgot there.
All right. In terms of the bathrooms to your left, are the bathrooms both male and female? Secondly, if we may please ask that we keep our phones on silent, please. I do understand during the week we might want to take some calls, but if we can put on vibration or else on silent, please, we'll dearly appreciate. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. In trying to continue the program, we try to be a little bit adventurous in trying to remember some of the life and the moments of Ugodv. Maybe I'll just start with one that I remember. My friend had a love had a passionate, deep love for cars. So, sisase rez. Waye ninyi moto eyayimbi iphuka abazali bakhe. You know, his parents had sacrificed this old ancient car for him that he used to take out every second day, park it outside at rez, he used to wash this old car. to a point that we call this cow pretty. You know, it was so terrible that it got us from point A to point B, but it was the prettiest thing in his eyes. And so his life was a reflection of seeing good in whatever situation. I think even to his last moments, some decisions of the cars that he would buy are very questionable. You know, from the greatest cars, some brand new, but most of them gave him problems. And he just had a passionate love for his cars. So maybe perhaps that's why it's not by chance that it's also a car that that makes us sit here today, and how he departed life. But I'll ask Victor maybe to come through and just to share some of his moments as his brother who he grew up with and journeyed the greater part of life and still till the very end was communicating with him. Dr. Victor Mofokeng, please, sir. Thank you.
Hlala ohlala nami lishoni lilanga ubusuku bufikile enkosi.
Amen. Baitepelang modimo lebotepe bahona bakahladu la kahutu. Arati uta mefuta umuka medi arena uti wasi ukisi shoka. Eben, two disclaimers. Please do forgive me if I might shed a tear. And secondly, please do forgive the amens, okay? If you're used to speaking to congregants, now and then it comes a second nature, amen? I'm also going to ask to mix the Sotho le English. Also, please do bear with me there. I've been tasked to come share my brother's life, the good moments, and the bed, and in general, just to give you guys an overview. And I do concur with the MCs, and I've been trying to also encourage some of the family members, friends, that let's celebrate the 37 years we had with Godfrey. It does come as a shock, it does come as heartbreaking, but in those years, we had some great times, and I'm one of two to confess. Godfrey was born in Virginia, Rahlaya, Virginia, Rahlama Plasing, Rahlaitis Komplase, Tikwe, as my brother corrected me. He's the second, so Reforharon, Kyapti Laki, Kyapti Blondi, Kyapti Tsidiso Kin. And I was his baby project. I think everyone knows. I'm the person I am today because of my brother. He loved me dearly. My brother, he grew up Uhuti Arata Sports. So all of us, I think people from back home, if they're here, they are surprised to see me and my brother actually thriving corporately, or rather academically, or rather in the workplace. We were very gifted, sports-wise. From cricket, rugby, athletics, soccer. We were gifted and were renowned. From early as primary school, my brother started making provincial colors, and then later in his walk or in his life, when he got to high school, that's where now he started cultivating and showing some leadership signs, where he still continued sports wise, but more now we started seeing an element of leadership. And I was telling some of the gents many years ago that it's a good thing that they come to him for mentoring, but I would rather have them look at his conduct, his discipline, especially his work ethic. Anyone in the office, they'll tell you that when it comes to my brother, what needed to be done was going to be done. So from as early as high school, he started showing his abilities as a leader. He was very competitive. Till today. He was a big Pirates supporter, a big Orlando Pirates supporter, all of us in the family. A funny story, when I was 11. Nekibata told the Pirates because I just lost to Chiefs. And I just want to tell you how deep our family loves Pirates. And I remember my dad opened the door and he said I should go. And he was serious, he was fuming. And everyone kept quiet, and my mom just carried on washing dishes like she's not going to be part of this, you know? And he just looked at me and he just went to go close the door, you know? Because he knew that this is the team that we support. So he was very competitive. So he went to HTS, HTS Welcome. And I did mention that we started seeing his leadership traits. We started seeing his discipline. We started seeing him thriving. My brother was very lovable. I'll give you that. If you met him for the first time, he'd always leave a mark, you know. He was one of those people who, in a room, was going to be noticed. And he loved church as well. So in HTS, we used to have this thing called CSFIA. So me and my brother, we used to be very fluent in Afrikaans, because we went from pre-primary schools, high schools in Afrikaans. So he was one of those people that were the leaders in this Christian society movement. I remember in assemblies every Monday, he would be the one who reads us scriptural readings. He was RCL from Standard 6. And mind you, we're talking about 18 years ago, 20 years ago, in an Afrikaner school. And for him just to go to that school, you had to be someone special. It was almost similar to your grade colleges. You didn't enter that school easily. Up until from Standard 6, up until Matric, and he was the first black deputy head boy. Till today, if you ask guys like Sean, guys who were there, they'll tell you like, Gorda was like no one else. You know, he was very strict. And people look at me, they say I'm very firm compared to him, especially guys who've worked with him, me and him. But I was telling Papa Blow that from since, my brother was always, it's only probably late in his years, I think maybe after kids, where he started being softer, you know. But my brother was a no-nonsense person. He would call you out. I remember this one time when I just started, internship, in Sandton, and I used to go see some SMEs, and I just happened to bunk, and he called me, and just checking up on me. And I told him, no, yeah, I'm somewhere sitting in the car, you know. He's like, no, man, you're at work. Okay, they don't see you, but you don't work for them. You have to make sure that you respect your work, you know. So as early as that, I mean, I was still in varsity, and I knew that when you come to the workplace, you need to do what you are supposed to do, what you paid for. So, yeah, that was Godfrey with regards to him being disciplined and him showing leadership signs. Yes, in rugby as well. In high school he got honors he played Craven Week from under 16 up until under 18. He played Free State again cricket from under 16 up until under 18. Even when he came to UJ. I think Bootle and them will concur. He also played for the under 90, under 21s, and under 20s with regards to his athleticness. And then he studied construction management. I'm not going to go too much into that. I think Bomkhuluwami will go into a detail. But 2011, that's when he finished. He finished his qualification with his master's. He was still planning to study further to do his PhD. And then from there he went to Anglo. From Anglo, he started with Bonnons as a graduate at Anglo, and then from there he went to Eskom, and then from Eskom, me and him started his entity many years ago. I think it was 2015, up until I stepped down, and then he continued with the business. A couple of highlights about my brother. It's what's been echoing throughout the whole week, especially back home. My brother had a big heart for people. He was one of those people, whenever you gave him a call, he'll try by all means to help you. And the pastor even at home said, you know what, Kiatshaba, because Tshidiso, people might take advantage of him. Motwapilwe jwalo, it's a different kind. But at home, for those who don't know, I also found out recently that he actually bought the whole congregation chairs. He bought the whole auditorium chairs. He done some great stuff with fixing the roof. And he was busy with some other projects that the pastor told me that side. My brother also liked good things. My brother had style, guys. If you knew my brother was second to none when it came to class, you know. Quality. And he'll tell you, my chief, you pay for what you get. I think most of us know that, man. He'll tell you, you pay for what you get. He used to like quality stuff, you know, from everything that he loved. He was very loud. I was with one of our church members during the week, and she told me, because they entered business leasing cars, and they were meeting for lunch, and the lady was going to serve them. When my brother laughed, she actually got scared and almost dropped the, you know, and she thought there was tension, only to find out, no, this man is laughing, you know. And the poor lady, who was just also surprised, okay, he's a bit loud, you know, because she doesn't know him like that. So he was very loud. He liked style, and I thought when I was writing these points, I was not going to put it in, but my brother was a very, very, very funny person. He was a very strange person, particularly when it came to his eyes. Abuti had this funny wandering eye, you know, and it got him into trouble, you know. It's funny because we used to talk about it, and most of the time, I would be the one telling him, you know what? And it come to me, sharp, sharp, wena, wait a langa, you know. And I'm like, to be honest, it's always good to acknowledge, and then you look away. I would do that more than 3 seconds, this is my danger, you know. But that part as well, Majita Hai, who lived with him more, will attest. As well as Tuesday, when I was with Buhle, because this whole week we've just been recapping, we looked at some of the stuff that this man actually did to fascinate us within our family and friends. And we just, Buhle brought it up, but this man was always the first to most of the stuff that we achieved, you know. He was the first to get a good paying job. He was the first to, within his colleagues and friends, he was the first to get a cum laude, a master's. He was the first to drive expensive cars or your super cars. He was the first ever youngest construction manager to work for a multi-million corporation. He was the first youngest Eskom portfolio manager. He was the first to introduce us to golf. I can tell you most guys here who didn't know golf, and some other family members, I just saw them. had that man not been there, I can tell you now they were just going to play rugby. They're just going to play rugby. But he brought along Ubuhle, and Buhle brought along his brothers. And guess what? Before you know it, we've got this Albatross Club. We're playing golf on weekends. Before you know it, now that this thing is big now. He was the first to get married, the first to have three kids, and I think the saddest one after him having three kids, after him achieving, even amongst us, he was the first to leave us. So, however, let us celebrate the gift that God gave us through Godfrey. The 37 years that he had were very impactful. We're talking about it with my brother, that some people live even more than 30 years, but the impact that they leave cannot be compared to people who actually came here for a purpose to grace people with their gifts. I just want to comfort us to say, God does give and God does take. The unfortunate thing about our human condition is that we are not ready for the joyride to stop. We just want that Muzwinki to keep playing, you know. And we know at one point, at some time, there has to be an end to that. And us as people don't appreciate that, you know. With those words, I would also like to encourage us. Towards Godfrey's final moments, similar as I mentioned in high school, that this guy used to be one of the head guys in the Christian Association. Even when we came to Res in 20, when I came to UJ in 2010, I found him and Buhle when they were battling the qualification. He'll attest, they used to pray. Mr. Kai is here as well, Gary Kai, you know. There used to be those people who actually were serious about their walk with Christ. Hence I'm saying, I want us to encourage us to also remember Hore, Christ is faithful in this time. Haru Klebuhloku Rehopo Lehore Modimo Natsibore, that's Ilina Tubati. Omohe Tetu Hore Amonke, Kaka accident. We know that we leave this world many ways. But the path that God had chose for him is this one. You know, only God knows why he chose that one. And only God knows at this why at this point in his life. You know. Other family members, Godfrey's kids, Godfrey's wife, we are there. You know. I was telling my wife and my other friends, when it comes to Godfrey's family, God is faithful. I can tell you that. Or bana ba ba tlo hola ba tlo kena sekolo ba tlo ba di professional le bona ba tlo hola ha monate jwa ka bana ba ba. It's just that us as people sometimes we fear because now the person who used to be there for them is no longer there, you know. Come on to our batswadi, with those words, I thank you very much for this opportunity to share with you guys Godfrey's life. Thank you.
Thabelo tsa rona Dita nyolo Dita nyolo Hela Hodimo Huntate Tabelo Zaruna Dita Hodimo Huntate Ribine Hosana Hosa Hosana For everything, there is a season, a time for everything, every activity under heaven, a time to be born, and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to harvest, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build up. There is a time to cry and a time to laugh, a time to grieve and a time to dance. Umntakwethu kumfundisi ke uyawutsho uba which scripture of the Bible that is. He's a ordained pastor. I don't mean to put him on the spot, but my understanding is that he knows the Bible inside out. Thank you.
We'll leave that one to the pastor who's assigned to preach for today, right? Yeah. So I met him now, Godfrey, 2016. I started at Eskom Rotech Industries 2016, and I was his portfolio manager. And during that year, we took a drive to Northern Cape, a very long one from here. And we drove over 2 days. I learned there that this guy is a mama's baby, a proper mama's baby. And I think our friendship grew from there because I'm also a mama's baby. So I realized how much common things we have between us. And when we drove back, arrived at office following week, he said, "My chief, I can go to war with you anytime. I'm pledging my support to you. I will go to war any day with you. I trust you." And I've never struggled with him. A year later, I promoted him. I was given a second portfolio, and I acted on another one, and then I promoted Godfrey to take over, to act. And we've grew up to be very close friends. He would call me any day. We'd call each other and says, "What am I?" But then he understands his suit. I will speak, the only person I understand is suit when he's speaking is Godfrey, right? Others have just blanked out, have no clue. But when Godfrey speaks, he would call and I would put him on speaker and would speak and I'll speak back in Sotho and my wife would look at me, "Since when?" Because we spoke every day, so I understood him clearly and understood the things he was saying because we would talk of common things. So we really lost Plaza Plaza. Last year, if it was not 2022, I think 2022, we drove quite a lot and we went, there was unveiling at his family. And I had met his dad before, but over that period, we were coming from Cape Town. It's a love driving, guys. We drove to Cape Town. We arrived in the morning. We drove back again to Welkom. Then we attended the unveiling. Then we drove back to Joburg. So I met his dad there, and he kept on saying, every time he's speaking, "Blaza, blaza, blaza, blazi." Like, you know, my dala utso utso, no? I fell in love with his dad. From that day, I started calling Zidzo Blaza Blaza, Dr. Vic as well, Blaza Blaza. So anytime we'd call each other, he would know. Either I say Ngwaname or I say Blaza Blaza. And he would say, "My chief, you're a clown." When I ask, every time I'm picking a call from you, it's like I'm going to hear my dad. I already know you're going to say Blaza Blaza. So on Saturday then, his father greeted, I introduced my wife to him. Sponon. Hello, Sponon. I was like, "I go badala, no?" You know, great family. I've grown to love the entire family. Maggie, the wife, the kids. What a great family we've come to know, thanks to Tsidiso. There's a scripture in the Bible that says, a child is born, but a son is given. It talks about Christ. I feel like Tsidiso was given as a son to the nation. He was born for his family, but he was given to us. As friends, as associates, as colleagues, he was really a great, he was a gift to Tsidiso. And it's also that we are speaking of him in the past. It's truly unbelievable. We will miss his laughter and his jokes and everything else we did together. We had good days.
Sorry,
we had good time, gentlemen. Really did. Let me just share this one. 15th of April, we had, last year, 15th April 2023, we had Wanda's, what do you call it? It's not a baby shower, right, Wanda? Amen. Baby splash, whatever you call it. So we met somewhere as gents and we brought gifts. So I was brying with some of the gentlemen sitting there, Abokaya and the likes. And then we asked Sidiso to piece the meat. It It was already ready. This is ready for Uguja. So we asked him to piece it up for us. Umchida, why piece it like a stir fry? Why cut it? Why cut it? Why cut it? Manja, we are done. We are ready to eat. We look at the meat. Oh, see this. Did you do it? Yeah, clown. What is this? Why cut it? Did they wait? Maybe, unfortunately, Abangas, Tina, we are Xhosa, we are Sotho. Maybe that's what you know. Mari, Tina, we need to, you know, we need nyam. Why cut like a stir fry, Mjida? And like, I maybe different cultures, they are very much. Thank you so much. I think at this time, let's give the siblings that they blow, Mr. Itumeleng Matlakwane, to say a few words on behalf of the siblings. Thank you. And let us do it together with Mr. Opa Sitela, the music director for this church. When he sings, please let's support him and sing together with him. Thank you.
Modimo riboka wena, riboka. Modimo riboka wena. Zoshe, zoshe. Kiwena Modimo. Zoshe, zoshe.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Program Director, and good afternoon, everyone. Actually, what is happening today, it's what God used to do to me, just hijack me. Bushe did the same thing. I checked the program this morning. I see my name in there. God, I should have said, you are poor, my chief. You are very poor. Yeah. It's one of those moments one doesn't know where to start. As much as I know where to start, but it's difficult. But yeah. Let us celebrate the life of God. If you want to get the picture of, I called him Goda. Just think of someone who used to play rugby and suddenly start playing soccer and try to mix the two. There's no match. That was Goda for you, my chief. Let me start. This man was one of those unique gentlemen. I must say, we had a lot of memories, fun, and at times it was sad. But I can tell you one thing, as much as I was old to him, I've learned a lot from him. He was one of those people, as we engage on something, on us a compromise, we wouldn't take chances, we'll go all out. We used to have these small anyana parties at home, and I'll be hijacked to say, be the program director, please. Then I was sure, the moment I see his car, I'm gonna be relieved from that responsibility because he was good at doing that, he'll take care of everything. I must say, we had a long time ago. I remember his first package when I received it. I think it was Anglo, yeah, Anglo. This man is saying, he's seeing this package. You can imagine someone graduating and getting this kind of a package. He gives me a call, hey, Papa Blo, hey, man, I don't know if maybe I'm puzzled or something. Please assist me here. What's wrong, my chief? Hey, man, they give me the package. I don't know if maybe they've got the numbers wrong or right. I'm like, send my chief, send, let's see what is happening. Yeah, then he sent the package saying, Then you look around, you say, are you sure Papa Blo is right? I'm saying, Chief, it's right. And this is the way the company is regarding you. That's how they are valuing you. Then he laughed, you know, he smiled. He will laugh. Someone from next door will hear that this man is laughing. Then he went on to say, Papa Blo, now that I'm here, he was driving a Corsa by then. He was driving Corsa by then. He said, Papa Blo, man, now I need to improve now. I need to move. What do we do? At the beginning, I used to be the master of that exercise, looking for the car for him. He'll call me and say, Papa Blo, how far are you, man? I need to get rid of this little Nyanakulu if I make you to get something nice. Then I'll take the whole week getting the call every day for that man to get a car. Then I happened to bump into this black Polo with a silver mix. I just threw it to him to say, my chief, we are not moving. We are here. Then he said, Papa Blo, I trust your eye. I know you'll never mislead me. The guy fell in love with the car. Jiggy, 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 this man is moving. Papa Blo, I think I'm done with this one. Let us move to the next one. I think Buhle mentioned that he was in love with the cars. He was like, Papa Blo, no, man. Hey, I need to move now. I'm a manager, man. I'm a manager. I should move into the level of the managers. Papa Blo, you know your work. Hey, this man, chief, give me the specifications. Talk to me. Ah, Papa Blo, you know blue and white is the theme for me. Blue and white, okay. Now I know what you're looking for. Then we went up and down looking for this blue and white badge thing. My chief, man, I'm not sure. Maybe you should just take your time and look around because I might mislead you. Then he said, no, I trust your eyes. I might make a decision, but yours I know. You'll never mislead me. Then definitely we managed to get something. That was, in actual fact, the route that we had with God as an introduction for the love of the cars. That man was in love with beautiful cars. Trust me. He will go and do anything to get what he wants in terms of the car. Personality-wise, I don't think we need to talk about about God. The face can tell. Just look at the face. He was one of those guys who will make everyone feel comfortable. And the same, God, Vic is right. He is the one who was championing this project of the golf. Yeah, he made it a point that at least we are in there and we fell in love with it. He will coordinate our games. He will leave the office just to go and book for all of us. And we'll ensure that at least we're comfortable and we play and we'll have fun. We'll have fun, we'll enjoy to the fullest. He was selfless, this man. He had this special heart, not only for the family, but for everyone. I must say, I had something that were troubling me. I never thought I'd talk. I was with Buhle yesterday. It was so heavy for me. I never thought I'd be standing here, but I felt I have to do justice to this man. He played a big role in my life as well. You know, he is one person who was passionate about academics. I remember I did my diploma. He'll keep on bugging me to say, my chief, diploma is not enough. People are pushy. If you are thinking about the promotion, you're not going to be stuck with your diploma. Keep on pushing. And exactly that's what I did. I started pushing. It was because of him. Vic mentioned earlier that he played a major role in his academics. Not only him, actually almost everyone. I must say, we had a great time with this man. I remember the other day, it was our first gathering at my place. He came. If you want to know how clownful this man was, I was hosting the family at my place. Then we were kicking the ball like Vic was saying, used to play. Hence I was saying, just imagine someone playing soccer, moving from rugby to soccer. So we are busy kicking the ball in front of the house. I'm worried about my windows. This man's going to break my windows. Then he just decided to kick the ball up. Then it got stuck in the tree. And it's like, my chief, he's old by then, my chief, I'm not going to go there. You're going to have to find a way because that ball should come down here. My kids wants to play with that ball. For some reasons, ended up being there. Then there comes the song. He's one of the favorite. He's there. And the song is playing. He doesn't know what to do. He started dancing there while standing on the tree. I'm like, my chief, what are you doing? It's like, my chief, I'm trying to balance the song and I have to get the ball. So yeah, that's God for you. I must say we had a great time. We spoke on the 27th. We had some lengthy chat. We spoke. We made an arrangement some time ago. If you want to understand how poor this man was in terms of management, we had a plan to attend the softball qualifiers in Polokwane a few weeks ago. Then on the 27th, when he calls me, he's asking me about the arrangements of that event. Chief, when are we going to the qualifiers? I'm like, Chief, that thing passed 3 weeks ago. Where are you coming from? He's like, Papa Blo, but you should have told me. You know, my chief, you knew, and you are the one who came with the idea of attending the qualifiers. So that's God for you. He will go all out to ensure that everyone is comfortable, everyone is happy, and he'll always set the stage for everyone to feel comfortable. We enjoyed his life until the unfortunate day of the 28th. And I must say, as much as Kiki Mietzwe, but I'm going to make it a point that we celebrate the life of this man. In those words, I love to say thank you very much.
Thank you, Papa Blo, for that moving speech from the family. I think just in touching, maybe Uvik forgot one thing. Godfrey was very competitive to a point that sometimes it borders crossing the line. That's how competitive he was. So this one time we're playing golf and he hits his ball into the rough. We all go, so kangeli polayak, is kangeli polayak. We decide, why asibon le polayak. And then, all of a sudden, he finds a ball. As we go out of the rough, we then find the actual ball. So now he's got two balls, and we're asking yourself, where did the other ball come from? So he was very competitive that he would try anything to win sometimes. And that's just the nature of person that he was. I think without further ado, moving to the tributes, can I just ask Babu Cheksin to please come through? I'm going to reorientate the program a little bit. I believe that he has to run. I just didn't want to miss him. So, Bra Cheksin, please, if you may. Bra Cheksin is Godfrey's very close associate and business partner. But he'll tell us more when he gets on to stage. Thank you.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like seas billows roar, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well, it is well with my soul, it is well.
Sanibonani. Sanibonani. Igama lami uJackson Mzobe. Ngiyabona ku program babhale Mzombe, akuyena Mzombe izimzobe. Indoda le uGodfrey. We met ngemsebenzi siyenzayo. I'm running an electrical company. Siqala ukwazana, he was working for Eskom Roshkon. I go to new places through Godfrey that I never been before. Now go Springbok. We are not to Springbok. The only thing I could do was speak English and in Kulum. And I had to find an interpreter because I couldn't prat. And then he was a good man. Leminyaka, a few years that I have known him and was a family man, was someone reliable, doesn't matter at what time of the day. I could call him maybe to 12 midnight, my brother have a problem here, can you assist? There were times when he was working in Limpopo, a mining. He used to come just to see me for my business dealings with. And I used to say, sometimes you must find time to rest because you are like me. He's feeling about Red Bull and the coffee, and sometimes not good. And then I brag, Skawara, not strong. Skawara chief is how he used to say. So, yes. Too much. And I'm holding myself back with Ngakali. Within the tender Langa car is Okala stage, Wongo Munda Peggy, but Nizubhum. Kubo Wonga Bandubin Seven Son and Abone. Ye no moon to be to America, you could send him anywhere, you can ask for anything. If a corner wins a Liona, he would. Yeah. Need the papi, and the Nindogam for King Sinani. Ngiyabonga.
Asim join. Thank you so much, my brother. We appreciate the song. And thank you, Gundate Jackson, for those few words. At this point in time, we will welcome U Sean as part of the Friends, as Gatsiso, to come say a few words. I see the young man in front of his wedding, Ipagani, in tribute of his uncle. Looking nice, son. Thank God you're not chiefs. It would be a bad tribute. Let's give over to Sean. Thank you.
Hola. Hello, everyone. My name is Sean. I didn't think they were going to call me out now. I was waiting for Modupi. And then it was going to be me. Oh, I haven't spoken in front of so many people in a while. So please bear with me. My English is not, doesn't sound like the program that anchors, and you know, but I'm going to Zama. But anyway, I'm from Velko. I keep telling myself, I don't want to forget anything. You understand? Sometimes you stand here, you want to say something, and then you forget it when you get home. You're like, yes, forgot to say that and that and that and that. But anyway, I'm a very easy outie. Very easy outie. And God has blessed me with two incredible friends. They've got a thing in university where they say the people that you're going to meet at university, you're probably going to meet your wife, you're probably going to meet whoever and ever, but those are the people that is going to be your immediate environment, as the people you're going to build your life with, and whatever, whatever. And I went to Bloom to go study in Bloom, but before I go there, let me just go back when we got to high school. But let me just say this. I lost two of my best friends. I lost Mike early in this year. And when they gave me the call that Guthrie's gone, it just broke me. And I sat by my girlfriend the other night. I'm not married yet. So I was sitting there by my Mary's house, and I was telling her, yes, as you know, it is... If I can, maybe... Let me not put it like that. But anyway, this year is really just, man, this year, 2024, okay, it's done what it's done. But it broke me tremendously, and I just sat there crying and said, yes, there's so much that we still wanted to go and meet this guy, man, in Chuba, because I've never been to his house in Jersey, and it's been how long since I've been out of Chuba. But anyway, I remember we were in standard 6, and most of us, we know obviously it's either soccer or cricket or what and what, but rugby was, you know, the last thing on the list, because the white guys were, but very big, man. They were they were huge, man. And the soccer ended, and now you have to find another sport, so I had to go play rugby. And when I get to the rugby, but I'm like a small, I'm not that big like Cora. I'm a small out team, and I look at my son the other day, and I realize, yes, I was a bit bigger than you. Mas, all right. Anyway, I get to the field, I find he's Cora, yes, China. There was another out there, I can't remember his name. Maybe it will come one day to me. My, he's the ones, man. They're here, man. And these guys are not, they're not trying to play rugby. They're making their mark there, their HTS, you know. I mean, people that have been to HTS, it's been as a serious, sorry for the word, obvious school. You know, white people, they don't want to. But we're there, young. Yeah, we just, sorry for the, I don't know how far I can go. Can I have my topic? Hey, man, we are playing, you. Just, I'm like, yeah, what a spark is for me, bro. Are you like, you know, so far look me, bro. We, yeah, man, we're playing you. And God has got the best position on the house. He's the fly off, man. You know, any rugby player that plays rugby, you know, fly off, that's where the heart of the game is. My friend has played at that position. But we played, young. We played, I played at standard 6 and then standard 7. We just started out, and then we got another coach, and I said, I'm going to focus more on my studies. But Gora kept playing, young. Yeah, I remember I went to the stadium to go watch Gora. Gora's weighing the 15. He's the smallest guy on the field. But Gora is there, young. I'm like, hey, Gora, you must now start playing, young, from the back. Start running from the back. You can't just... You can't just kick the ball, man. Start running in and taking on the guys. And, hey, man, Agora had a huge, huge, huge heart and a huge love for rugby. But like I said, you know, we all went our separate ways. I went to Bloom, he came to Joburg. And that was about that. And I thought, hey, man, I'll probably never see anyone after that again. And then, surprisingly enough, I came and did my training here in Joburg. And I don't know, did I call Gora? Or how did he call me? But yeah, the next minute, yeah, I get a phone call. I'm in Boksburg. I think Gora was somewhere here, central. He's like, hey, but she's no, he's not Joburg. No. Oh, Gora, I'm here, I'm Joburg. And what? Yeah, this place, man, I don't know what to do. Weekends, I'm just, you know, I'm just sitting around. Hey, man, what can I do? He's like, hey, Sean, hey, man, I'm going to come through. Just tell me, just give me the address. I'll be there now. So I'm telling myself, I haven't seen Godfrey in a long, long time. Probably very long time. And this guy comes, man, from I don't know even where. And Gora comes to where I told him I am in Boksburg. Yeah, man, I was so happy to see this guy. I'm like, yeah, Gora. He's at least not crazy, bro. At least you're not gray yet. You know? And you know, I had friends in Bloom, and the guys were this side. But you know, everyone, when they get to the corporate, to the working world, they're so professional and so formal, they don't even want to pick up a phone call. But yes, that's how they led from high school, he's Gora. Yo, I think the first weekend I could have gotten to Gora was here. That's when I met Putle, Smolza, Isme Ultimate Threats. Yeah. There was another out here from Velas. He was also here. Sorry, man, for my way of talking, man. I can't speak that serious English. But anyway. We had some hard times, you know. No, we had some hard times. I remember we went to the club one weekend, you know, me, Putle, and Bajida Smolza. We were there. We went, you know. I'm out there, we went out. Oh. So Gora, I didn't know, you know, according to me, Gora was closer, so obviously, the ones that can jive, yes. So he ended up being in the middle of the circle and everyone is around and Gora didn't say, hey, Mona, stop my thing. Yo, I. So when he found himself now in that situation, he's now, you know, everyone's looking at him and he just had to make a move there. I'm like, hey, Gora, come eat. Come eat me, bro, come eat. But it was Gora, man. I know Gora didn't touch alcohol. I don't know, did he later start drinking, didn't smoke. I was my out there, drank and smoke. And I think me and Mike were the ones that we were just, you know. And I remember one night, said, hey, Shona, if you're going home, pick me up. I also want to, well, here's his aunt as well. I can still remember you. You're on the west side, no? Yeah. I saw her now, and I'm like, oh, he's here, now. He's got us an auntie, no. But anyway, we're driving home, man. And it's late, man. I'm thinking, yeah, Gora, it's like, Shona, take the Paris Road. We're going to Paris Road. But you know, you can speak. Gora was, Gora was just out there, man. You know? We're driving along Paris. I'm like, hey, Gora, hey, man, how many times have you driven this road? Are you sure the path is? Nah. Yes, you're on a Rayman. Yes. And we're driving. Now it's becoming quiet, man. Yes, you're on this time of the night. I call my mother. And so I want to call my mom. Hey, that guy spoke to his mom from, I think, I don't know, from what time to what time. But his mom was at work. And, when they said he was a mama's boy, I just realized, hey, Gora couldn't say, ma, pial, you know. He could have called his mom, you know. And I forgot now what I wanted to say. But, you know, we become so busy and And the last thing you think about is, you know, something like this can happen, especially, you know, this time of the year. Anyway, I just want to say to Vic, I remember the time when I went to go fetch God and we had to come back to Joburg. I went in and I told your mom, we prayed already because my dad prayed for us already. And then your mom was like, hey, man, come in. What is, man? Come in. We haven't prayed here yet. And his mom started praying. And Vic prayed. And Cora prayed. We all prayed. And we left. And we came here safely. And I always want to say, my man, I don't know, time like this, what do I tell you? I can only say, hey, man, stay on your knees, me, bro. It's helped me. It's helped your brother. It's helped all of us, me, bro. And to Cora, thank you, my auntie, for allowing me to be in your world, to meet your friends, you know, for making me feel like I matter. I'm not an easy auntie to get along with, but you made me feel like I matter, and I hope you rest in peace, man. And thank you very much, man, for letting me be a Vic. I really appreciate it, man. Thank you, all of you, man. Thank you, bye.
Jabayaka. Fatsi lena ke ho riki rate jeso le ho tsebisa le ho tsebi saba heso tabo eli homo Lampirisa Rato 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 Lahai Liansi Disa.
Thank you, Shona. I think everybody's had a fair laugh and you've set the bar the right tone. I was worried there for a second that you'd say a thing you shouldn't say. But I was relieved when you did it. with that being said, can I please call on Mutupi? He's also one of Godfrey's very close friends that has journeyed with him.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is deep. This is heavy for me. We go a long way with Godfrey. I think I known him from 2006. It was our first year at UJ. And I don't know if this was a coincidence or anything, but our student numbers was the same except for the last number. His last number was number 5, I was number 6. So I agree with everyone that has been standing here and saying he was a very joyful person, very loving, very funny as well. I remember there was one time that we went home at his home with Upriti. It was a very long drive because we needed to stop now and then to make sure Upriti has water. So it took time to get there, and when we got there, it was very late at night. And I remember he was telling his mother he's going to borrow Priti again for tomorrow, he's going to Bloemfontein. Like everyone that has said, he loved traveling. He loved traveling, and he can drive. So the following day, we went to Bloemfontein. And in Bloemfontein, I also have friends. So we went to his friends first, and as our way back, we went to my friends. And we stayed there for about 3-4 hours, and when we looked at time, it was around 2:30 in the AMs. And if everybody knows me, ke motuli metya bij. So, ulankemela, aduti kantle, waiting for me to come out. He called me 3 times, and the 4th one was like, "Ai chief, usolo moholo, o tla ipona." And then he left, went back to Virginia. So I lost my phone that day. So when he got there, he tells me his mother was like, because his mother used to call me Pikinini. So his mother says, "Uyenzeka Pikinini yabantu, ukai." And then he said, no, he slept at his friend's place. But the following morning, he was made to go look for me. You know, that's how loving that family is, and they have welcomed me with warmth and love. And everybody that knows Godzo knows what I was always there with him everywhere we go. We were even mistakenly for brothers. We are brothers, but everyone was like, "No, man, we've always thought you guys are coming from the same family." But yeah, it is. He was my family, and I think through him, I gained another family in Welcome. And you will know when we go home and we go to Free State, I will also try and go home with him. Yeah, no, he was a very fun person to mention a few, and everyone else has said that. But I remember there was this other time, and just before I go there, he said when he has his mindset on something, there's no way that you can change him. So through our journey of trying to make it in this life, we tried to have an office. We had an office, and you know, things just didn't work out at some times. And 1 month we were locked outside our office. There was this tender that we needed to submit. And we sat there at his house and we're like, "Chief, we have a step ladder. Our sliding door is always open. We must make a plan." He didn't think twice. We took the step ladder, we went to the office. We asked the security to come in, they opened, and then we put the stepladder up, we went in, we worked. That happened for about 3 days until they found out, man, these guys, these clowns are here. So, yeah, and then the following day, I think we were told not to come in until we paid. Luckily, that was the day that one of our clients had made payment on our invoices, and we could make it right. But when everyone said he was a goal-driven person, very passionate about what he's doing, and he would always say to me, "I know, Chief, you can make it. We have it in you." Even though at sometimes I was doubting myself, he would always say, "You have this." I remember early this year when we normally have a caucus meeting just before the year starts. And it was very joyful and very hopeful for this year. There are a lot of appointments that we were hoping to get this year, and some of them came through. And he said to me, this is the beginning of the good life and the good things that's going to come. And it's unfortunate today that all of those things are coming while he's not here. But I'm happy that he was the one that pushed us through it and made sure that we are where we are today. I think everyone can attest, our businesses and as individuals, he touched you to move forward, to make sure that whatever you are doing in your life, it's very positive, and to make sure that you're living the life that you will want one day regret and say, I should have done 1, 2, 3. You know, they said he was a sporty person. I know he was, because this other time, because I only played soccer, so rugby, cricket, it was new to me. I'd never watched it. I don't know anything about cricket. So there's one time he went to his home. I think Uvictor was playing on Saturday. He was in Kimberley. And then he said to me, today I'm going to teach you cricket. We went to go watch him in Kimberley, and I'm not a fast learner, but at least that I knew what was happening, because he was here and he helped me through it. And right now I can proudly say I know and I understand rugby and cricket thoroughly. And golf, he was just starting to get me into it. He would trick me and say, Chief, there's one client I want you to meet. But it always has to be at the golf club. And I would like, no, man, Chief. At the golf club, he's like, yeah, just come as you are. I went there, and when I got there, he bought my first golf clubs for me. And then he was like, today, this is the beginning of you playing golf. The following month, he wanted to invite Abu Uwutle, but we couldn't because we had other commitments somewhere. That golf club has been standing there. I think I've used it 3 or 4 times with him, only him, because I couldn't play very well. So he was like, before you start, I need to guide you, Chief. Yeah, you cannot be a clown around my colleagues, you know. So yeah, I needed to make sure I understand and play golf. He was a very caring person. I mean, we all know back in school, we used to stay together. We had this thing, so I used to be outside. I was a naughty one, so I used to be outside a lot. So when they would cook, as about they finished cooking, he would text me and say, hey, leader, you must get your ass here. Sorry for the language, but he'd be like, you must get yourself here. You know, that's how much he cared about me. And from then, from tertiary, we went through everything until today that we sharing an office with him. It has been pretty rough years for us, but the last few years has been good and bad. But I think with all those words, I'd like to say, we have lost someone that was dear to us, but I think he has paved a road for all of us. As he used to say, before you can see the sunlight, there has to be darkness. This is our darkness now. And yeah, the light is coming. Rest well, my leader. Sleep well, Brawaka. We have gained an angel. I know you will look over all of us, family, friends, and everyone that you loved. You will protect us and be there. Oh, Lifule Sefu. Oh, le fule se hlo nka metswalle metswalle nyao. Oh, le fule se hlo nka motswadi baneng ba hae. Oh, le fule se hlo nka malume batshaneng ba hae. Holy for se hlo onka brother siblings in tsahai lifu o se hlo onka ntate baneng ba hai lifu o se hlo onka monna mosading wa hai ah empa ho lokile ntate ke thato ya hao.
Tato ya ha
Thank you for that, small. I found myself doing things that I wouldn't normally do. I found myself being ill-disciplined to self. And I hold myself accountable whenever I do such. But of late, in the last week, Godfrey's been an excuse. He'd always say to me, you are your own boss, your own timekeeper, but respect that office that you've been put in. If you don't hold yourself accountable, you can't hold anyone else accountable. So small, Godfrey will not be here to hold you accountable anymore. The responsibility is now on self. He's given us the blueprint to carry on. From all of us, I think, Akona sitting here, Alberto sitting there, and myself standing here. He gave us the blueprint when we all started. And he drove us to heights that we should multiply even those that come after us. So worry not, my friend. You'll have the answers, even if you don't see them clearly from the onset. Guys, in keeping with time, can we please move with the program? I'd like to call on Utandi and Koketso. I saw KK somewhere. I spoke to Tandi earlier, and I know that they had a bit of a challenge, but Koketso is here to be able to speak on their behalf. Thank you.
I don't know where to start. But I'm here as Godfrey's friend, also on behalf of my wife, to just share a word. I'm actually starting to develop a lump in my throat because it's so surreal. I think from, maybe let me start with me. How I met Godfrey is through my wife. Went to the same school, they were in the same class. And that's how I also met Buhle and your nonties and the likes. So it's like a flashback. Godfrey was a brother to a lot of us. I lost my brother 2 years ago, tragically too. But I think for more than anything, this man has been a brother to me, myself. Through whatever challenges that we went through in terms of business. I remember in 2020, on the peak of COVID, I reached out to him because I'm a contractor, and I had a couple of contracts, and I said, you know what, my brother, I'm struggling. It's peak COVID, and I've got these contracts I need to fulfill. And do you know anybody or if you can assist? And he reached out and, you know, he assisted me. Obviously, we used to play golf together when he used to play golf and the likes. So he's played a very crucial part in my life, my business, my wife's business, as a friend. And I will never forget him for that. Humble guy, steadfast. You know, very disciplined individual, I think, from what my experience was. And, you know, looking at Buhle and just hearing what he was saying, I think between the two, he would always call all of us to order, call Buhle to order. Buhle has always been a wild card, but I think, you know, in our experiences when we were in Swaziland, man, yeah, that guy was something else. And I think for me, it's you know, when trauma like this comes through, it's very difficult to handle. I don't wish it upon my worst enemy. I don't wish it upon anybody. I think to Godfrey's brother and family members, Midupi, the best thing you can do for yourself, and I'm talking from experience, is to work on that guy's legacy, to work on what the guy's left you guys. And that's the only way you'll find healing. Because if you try close whatever chapter when the time is not right, it's going to haunt you for the rest of your life. Whatever that man has left you, whatever that man has walked with you, pick it up and hold him up high, hold his name up high, hold his legacy up high. Never forget his kids, his wife. Make sure that you look after them, because at the end of the day, it's what he has left for all of us and for you in this life. So I'm deeply sorry for you. I know what you're going through. I hope you find the strength to ensure that you hold the family together, his business together, so that at the end of the day, he can still look down on you and smile. You know, for me, Godfrey, you know, and he never, one thing I can always remember is, like Buhle, there were times where he never used to pick up the phone. And yeah, he's in business, and when he got into business, I was like, you know what, my man, how is it that you run a business and you can't even pick up a phone, you don't even return calls? I failed to understand, you know, but he said, look, he's got his ways. Well, he was actually referring to Buhle more than anything, and he was also struggling to get a hold of that man there all the time. And I would complain, say, hey, Chief, that brother of yours, I don't know. And you guys live like literally kilometers away from each other, but I think I would like to remember him as a special person in all our lives, in my life, and the role he played in my life, my wife's life. I was in Cape Town when I got the call, and I just heard Midupi call me. He said, look, have you heard the sad news? And at that time, I was busy with some artists I work with, and I said, you know what, my brother, I don't want to take this thing without giving you my full attention. Let me help these guys and so that they can move forward, and then I will give you my full attention, because I could hear from his voice the sadness that came across. And then after that meeting, my wife called me and told me that Godfrey's gone. And it was so unreal. It was a difficult thing to accept, because I've got so much fond memories with that guy, with the gents, with everybody we went to school with. I think for me, that is my part in short. And I pray for the family. I pray strength to the family so that ultimately, at the end of the day, they can also find peace. It takes time, but one day you will be able to find closure in whatever way that means for each and every family. I think for my wife, she was shattered. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here for family reasons, but she was shattered. And more than anything, she wishes and prays for the family, for the wife and kids. We do be you guys as well. But strength to you, and I believe in time things will be a bit better. But don't forget that man's legacy. Work on that man's legacy. You'll find solace and healing in that. Thank you.
Asimzam gakhona kamatsogo. Ke matsogo, right? Besam Godfrey. I never used to call him Godfrey. I used to call him Sidisa. Yeah. Hey, we had a good time in Swaziland, my brother. Those memories were beautiful. I was just angry on the first night. I won't tell the reasons why I was angry. But one of them was that, okay, KK was very late, so we picked him in Midrand, and then we drive in two different cars. We get there, and I don't see my friend the first night. Somebody gave him dacha. And he got to his room, and he locked himself in. So I get there, I knock all night, Umjita cannot even hear us. And only in the morning, he came out, shy about what happened. But Chief, on the first night, we have not even settled, they discussed the plan for the weekend. Gone. So I respect that. I don't think we must try it at all. let's not try it if we have not tried it. Those who are trying it as ye again, let us stop it. At this point in time, let me acknowledge the father of the house, Apostle John Nabesha, who's the senior pastor of this house. Mhlekazi, if ungaphakama njabu khona back, he's sitting. Oh, there he is. That's the senior father of the house, Apostle John Nabesha. He will grace us with a word later on in the program. At this stage, there she is. Ushon said, when you go to Varsity, you never know who you're going to meet, the friends. You might even get a wife there. Some of us were really blessed at Varsity. We got wives. I mean wife, not wives, not me.
Swaziland.
So I will, at this time, I'll give my wife to come and render a song. And then after that, we'll give my good friends, Don Maloyi and Tabiso Maloa, former colleagues, Zgatsi Diso and myself, from ERI, which is Eskom Rotech Industries. I'm not sure, Don, if I must tell you now what we used to call you or must tell you later. You will see when Don comes to the front that he's very tall, and I'm a size 5 shoe, I'm short. So we used to call him Square Shoes because his shoes were very long and very... So there was another gents which we named not CD. So have you seen Square Shoes? No. Square Shoulders? So there were Square Shoulders and there were Square Shoes. We had a good time at the ERI with these people. I think one of the things I'm going to do after the funeral is what they always used to do. I cannot understand people who love hot stuff, hot food. So we'd buy chicken legin during break. And these guys would buy extra sauce, extra hot. And then Tito would also buy the spice. What do you call that spice? There's also salt fire, and then we'll buy extra salt. The one you fish, you call it in club. Salt and vinegar. Umjita would travel with that thing. I never used to understand him. And I think on Saturday after the funeral, Siakal, I just want to try these things that he loved so much. Thank you so much for your time. So immediately after my wife, Dawn and Tabiso will come to the stage. Thank you. Tata Lini Mnandini.
Siya Kinwa, Noma Gunga Tini, He Sanleni, So Musa. Siya Kinwa, Noma Kungatini. sandleni so musa. If you know how it feels to be kept, siyagcinwa noma noma kungathini sandleni so musa. Can you sing with me? Situation, you are the pillar that holds my life. Master, Jesus, you are the pillar that holds my life. Master, Jesus, you are the pillar that holds my life.
Is it on? Okay, thank you very much. My voice is very, very deep and very low, so I hope everybody can hear me. I'm audible enough. Should I say ladies first? Okay, she says please.
Death, be not proud. Lehu le setlhogo ka nnete. Lehu ke letete, lehu ke moriti. Re sepela nalo. I think in most cases when death happens, we ask questions but we don't have answers. And one of the biggest question is, why him? Why now? Yet we don't know the covenant he had with God. And in most cases, it could be for our own selfish reasons. Tshidiso was a giver of note, very generous. It's so hard for me to stand here and speak about him in past tense. On the 21st of March, the Thursday before his departure, we had a 40-minute phone call. We spoke again the Tuesday and the Wednesday when I received a message from Sibu. I was on the road. I was on the N1. And I thought I didn't see it properly. I actually pulled over on the roadside. And the first thing that came to my mind was his unapologetic laughter. And immediately after that, I phoned Sivu because I thought, what kind of a sick joke is this? Sivu didn't pick up. I called Tiso's number. And I was hoping to hear his voicemail at least that says, hi, good day, this is Godfrey. I didn't hear that. I had the automated voicemail that I've never had when I called Tshidiso. My chief, my leader, my blaza wa Sivu, my skat, my loving, my chom. We don't know why what happened the way it did. But all we can be grateful for today is the time that we shared with you and the memories that we created. We are grateful for that. God lent you to us and he has taken you back home. The good ones die young. And we always wonder why, because they still had so much to offer. I think Tshidiso had given. Tshidiso had offered himself. Yet we still, as people, we still wanted more. We still wanted to take from him. That's in our nature as people. We just want to take. And takers have no limits. And God loves his people. I personally still am reeling from a loss. And he was the loss of a parent. And as someone that has also lost a parent, he was there. I met Tshidiso in 2017 when I joined ERI. He was one of the first few guys that was introduced to me. And there were two guys, him and Joe Chibura. He said to me, Miska, don't worry. I am here for you and I'm going to support you. And I thought, oh, well, that's cliche. That's what everybody says. I can tell you those two guys, even to this day, even with the departure from ERI, they had been there for me, and Tshidiso is one of those. He had never left my side. He supported me throughout. Somebody spoke about how he supported them in their academics. I owe what I learned at ESCOM to Tshidiso. He knew I would need shielding, and he was exactly that to me. He never left. He never left. Tshidiso was a guy that would say to me, don't worry, this one will cover. The Springboks that somebody mentioned, I was also one of the people that were sent to Springbok. Sivu, yes, he did say, I would take Sivu to war any day. That's what he would say to me all the time. He would get to my office and he would look so distraught. But you knew, you put Tshidiso on the street, he would run. You put him in the boardroom, he would sign on the dotted line for you. That was Tshidiso. So, Sifu, it is difficult for me to think of me and you without Tshidiso. It's unthinkable. I can't. During the week, you said to me, Chomam, I don't know how I'm going to be an uncle to his kids in his absence. I felt that. Today we stand here, we remember a remarkable individual whose presence touched the lives of all who had the privilege of knowing him. TGM, as we affectionately knew him. He was a great colleague, he was a great friend, a great mentor, a source of inspiration to all of us. But most importantly, a brother to me. A very dear brother, a very dear friend. He was just 6 weeks older than me. Why did you leave us so soon? It's a question that we'll keep asking ourselves, but we didn't have any appointment, we didn't have any discussion with him and God. Only the two know. And all we can do right now is cherish the memories we shared with him. And somebody, Koketso, spoke about the legacy. That's what we need to do. We need to hold on that, and we need to pay it forward. That's who he was. God knew I'd need shielding in the workplace, and he was there all the time. You, Joe, Don, you knew I needed to do this. I think through death, I have learned to be strong, even if I didn't want to. But most of all, I have learned that every day could be your last, and the least I can do is to be kind to those around me and try to do good as much as I can. We mourn the loss and reunite, and you reunite with your mom. Let us celebrate the legacy they leave behind. Your memory will live on in the work we continue to do, the lessons we have learned, and the friendships we have forged. May we strive to honor your legacy and embodying the same spirit of kindness, dedication, positivity that defined Tshidiso Godfrey Molefe Mofokeng. Chomam, rest in peace. My dear friend, my twin brother, you are indeed a sister's keeper. You will deeply be missed and never forgotten. Death, be not proud. Till we meet again, good night.
Let me greet you again in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm also from Velcom, and I said to him, maybe it's a coincidence that we met. We also met around 2018 when we got to be given a responsibility of portfolios. Little I knew how young Godfrey was, or Matsidi, I used to call him. So we bumped each other on the corridors now and again, and I was wondering, who's this guy talking Sesotho Sena, say, Samonana, Nekili Monana, and no, but the only people that speaks like this, Kibatswam Freistata and Mutsitabong. So, I didn't want to ask at that time, so I timed him and I said that back to him, like, hey, Mfethu, kinekile kamonana, and he says, we're not welcome. Like, yeah, how did you know? He says, yeah, the only people who speak Sesotho like this, kibakasiaka. So we started calling each other Mataka, and so we then got promoted in a way to act when Sifu left the office as an HOD. Tshidiso moved in, and then I headed the distribution, the transmission, I mean to say. So Our office were adjacent to each other, and one day I was just sitting in my office and it was late. There was going to be a Mencom the following day. I just heard something bouncing on the door. It's like a person is knocking. I thought, okay, I thought I was alone here. And then I went to go check, and there was Sidiso with a pata and a ball in his hand. Like, dude, why don't you go to a World of Golf and why do you practice? I didn't even know at that time that he was playing golf. So I think our friendship grew stronger to a point where, because our scopes were similar, transmission and distribution, so wherever he goes out, and because he was a go-getter, to get projects, he would tag me along. So we drove to Kimberley, and the following day was a holiday. I think it was a long weekend. Sidiso booked us Thursday to Friday, and we went. On my way, I'm saying, but Chief, you're driving slow. Have you made an appointment? He says, no, Chief, we're just going to bulldoze that guy. I've worked with his senior before, so we're just going to go in and team. When are you going to do that? No, tomorrow. Matsidi, it's a holiday tomorrow. Christ, he had to phone that guy and begged him. I think we met him around 6 o'clock. We had a meeting until around 9. Now I'm saying, Munna, how do we explain coming back from Kimberley or sleeping in Kimberley over the holidays? Rumataka, we're driving back. And we drove back. Same day we drove back from Kimberley, we got home early hours of the morning. That day. But what I'm trying to get to is people that are working or that worked at Eskom would know that they have values that underpins their operations. I can't remember them from the top of my head. I'm not an Eskom employee anymore, so I have rusted a bit. One of them was excellence, integrity, innovation, Sinobuntu. I would just like to end it at that, given the time. But I think all these values were embedded in this gentleman. The latter speakers have said it all. I can't repeat it. An epitome of a leader, he was. Both of us are no more within the employment or a formal employment, but we are on the street and we followed him. So that's the leader that we had. I'm talking about him in the past just disturbs me. But that's the leader we had in Sidiso. I think on a day before her tragic departure, he phoned me and I was with a partner in the car, and he was still pursuing another work at the mines. The guy is a golfer as well. So he said, Don, if you can't arrange a golf game, I'll arrange it myself on your behalf, and then you invite me and tell him that we are coming there. So we're going to bulldoze them, Chief. This is our year. Little I knew that a day after that, I'll receive the news while I was still sitting with the same partner that was in the car with me. So, Mudimu Haitse Poso, I think he wanted to earn an angel within his team, an energetic angel. An angel that has got Sinobuntu, that has got innovation. I can talk the whole day about Sidiso. He was suspended at some point. And mainly, for not adhering to a policy that was drafted by a person, and the policy that was working against Tshidiso's people. And he told me that, Chief, I'm not bending, I'm just stretching the law. Now you're in trouble. I think Sivu Kiyena was suspended, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, but he was suspended, and so our last words before Atzamaya, he said, go and read Daniel chapter 6, verse 4. But it's about Daniel that was thrown in the lion's den, and he went out with no harm. So he had said to me, Chief, throw me in the lion's den. I'll come leading the pack. So that's the guy that you had. With all being said, the family, you just gained an angel with much more strength that will ensure that we thrive for what he lived for. God bless you all.
Morena utsiba matata aruna. Morena utsiba leseri sehloka tapelo tsaru. Nyuluhela dika nyuluhela ho dimo undate.
Thank you. I think, colleagues, I'm going to ask two people to come at a time. I'm just looking at time and I'm conscious of that. I understand we did start late, but please bear with me. I'm not going to rush you. But we are on a time constraint. With that being said, I think even Tshidiso himself is falling on the side. So he wants us to leave. I think he's had enough of the speeches. So let's make it short and sweet on his behalf. Can I please ask his Anglo colleagues, Small, Nonons, his former colleagues, I believe they're both not an Anglo. I'm not sure of this thing of not being there anymore. But it seems to be a trend of all his colleagues not being at their former places. But please, guys, thank you. Please make it short and sweet, guys. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. As I've been directed, I'll be short and sweet. My name is Nontebogo Sithole, and I've been asked to share my memories with Godfrey from Anglo Platinum, as a colleague from Anglo Platinum. Godfrey and I go back from university. We both studied building science at UJ. When I started at UJ, most of the students were already there, so it was very clicky. And I was a tomboy, so I gravitated towards the guys. And there's a particular area that we all used to sit at. The guys know the stairway on the fourth floor where fun things happened. That's where I met Godfrey and we became friends. Not friends deeply, but an associate from class. We were then fortunate to be chosen, together with Uzaze and Uwilda, to do our in-service training at Anglo Platinum. It's then that I got to know him better and we became very, very good friends. We were then formally employed by Anglo Plat upon the completion of our studies. There we learned a lot from practicing our profession to learning soft skills like work ethic that everyone has spoken about, that Godfrey was well known for, together with time management and punctuality, which at some point was a stickler for, but I think as he evolved, and because of his friendship with someone, he became a bit shaky in that regard. Gods was a go-getter. He didn't wait for opportunities to come to him. He actually created opportunities. An example of this was when he totally disregarded a development path that was charted out for us at Anglo as new graduates. Because it was linear, you needed to do this, and then after completing it, you'd do that, and so forth. Godfrey thought that was a waste of time. He then decided, actually, we had a big corporate, so we can learn everything at the same time. Why should we do it linear? So an example of this is when Godfrey would disappear, and we'd be supposed to be doing something, and Godfrey would be nowhere to be found. And it'd be for weeks. And when he comes back, I'd be like, but Ndani, where were you? And he'd be like, no, I was at whatever mine. I was shadowing a PM there, I was shadowing a scheduler or a mine specialist or whatever. He understood very early in his career that his growth and his success was squarely dependent on him and him alone. If street smart and work smart was a person, it was definitely God's. We grew together professionally and personally, and we became family. I mean, we lived down the road from each other. As kids, went to school together. Our daughters, our firstborns, are actually best friends. So he became a family, my brother. And we also experienced big life milestones together, such as getting married, as I've said, having and raising kids, loss when he lost his mother, life challenges and achievements. We went through all of it together as friends. I never knew, never in a million years, did I imagine that I'd be standing somewhere and be referring to Godfrey in the past tense at his memorial service, ever. It makes no sense still. It'll take a while for it to sink in. Tumone and the girls, to Rakhadi, to Victor and the brothers, to the entire Mofokeng family, the colleagues, the friends, ngithi alehlanga lingahlanga phephisane. When all of this was happening and I got the news, the one thing that I kept on saying, ukuyiduduza, is that at least he's going to be reunited with his biggest supporter, his loudest cheerleader, Umam Mofokeng. It was an honor knowing you, my friend. Rest easy, Chief.
Maula lengokolo, Maula lengokolo, Maula lengokolo, la 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 la, sizo kukumbula. Sizo kukumbula, sizo kukumbula, la la gale besi na lindele besi. Lindele, besi,
I'd like to honor the apostle of the house, the family, the program director, the colleagues and friends, and everyone. I used to be Gottfried Senior at Anglo, and we grew to be family, because to me, Gottfried is family. Remember when I found out the first person, then I called Nonce, because I thought it was an April Fool's, because it was the first. And she says yes, and I send another message. Nonce, are you sure you're not playing with me? It's not an April Fool's joke. But indeed, it was not a joke. And I was just reminded that I spoke to Gottfried where he found his death for a long time. We spoke for almost 45 minutes while he was driving on Thursday, you know. And part of me wants to believe that Gottfried knew he was going. And let me tell you why. I did leave Anglo, worked somewhere, and we still became very close. We used to call our boss Pharaoh, you know, this white man. And so I said, hey, God, I'm not going to write him as my reference. So you're going to be my reference, my friend. So the sad thing is that even on Tuesday, when I know he's gone, they say, write the reference. I'm writing Gottfried. And in my heart of hearts, I know he's not there, and I don't know why. So it was my birthday on the 15th. I was in a meeting. Gottfried tried to call many times because we never forget each other's birthday, and he didn't find me. So I don't know how he decides to call my sister. And my sister said, oh, it's a miracle. You call me. Because he started by saying happy birthday, and like, hey, Gottfried, to who? You see? And then now they start talking about God stuff. And when they started talking about God, eventually he finds me and tells me happy birthday, whatever, you know. But he was a very amazing person, and the journey, working with him, having him report to me, someone once asked him to say, God's, because they thought I'm quiet, but I'm not really quiet, but he said, someone from Anglo said, this person laughed the loudest when she's with you and not, but you'll always just, I thought she's a quiet person. That's who he was, Gottfried. And I mean, I even remember when the mom was sick, we would every day set an alarm, pray 12 o'clock and 3 o'clock. And that's the part I want us to remember. Gottfried knew where his Redeemer and his strength was in God. And, you know, just being there, you know, he will call me Wanesu, but when he calls Arinjaga, then I know that is the time that Ruwa Magunutu. And the reason he calls me my Njaga, it means dog. The reason for that is because I once told Gottfried that my mom was working somewhere with an older woman. And the woman said to her, my child, always learn that when you have problems, you rather talk to a dog because it will never tell anybody. It can rather say, and your stuff are safe. So every time he says Njaga, I know we're going to go into those things that people shouldn't know about, you know. And on Thursday before he left, he started by saying Njaga, Harweza Nja. You know, meaning we're talking now deeper stuff. And we spoke, we gave each other and said, you know, you're my sister. And if there's one thing I want you to do, then I started to tell her, him thinks about me, that he also knows, like, please, I want to arrange, you must meet my aunt. You and her, you will click, and what you've been through, my aunt has been through, and she's doing much better, so you're gonna be fine. And I encouraged him. Also, we spoke. There's so many things I can talk about Gofi. Even when I heard that he passed on, every time we travel, we'll travel many times to different mines, the three of us. So there's a song by Inkom. It's a song called, sing by who? I even forget that. I immediately went to that song after hearing that Gofi passed on. And you never know how much you care about a person. I remember the last time I cried was when my grandfather died. But that day I went straight home and I just couldn't help it. So we really lost a very persistent person, a soldier, a child of God. He stayed many nights with me, helping me to type my master's report. So I will miss you. I will miss the family. And he loved his children. He loved his family. Whenever he comes to see me, he comes with the girls. So, Robalaka Kodzo, I know last year you called me and you say, can you believe so? It's my mother's 10th year since she died. And he started crying. And I said, Njaga, he's with the Lord. So you decided to follow her, and may your soul rest in peace. Forever love you. And for the last thing, I have to ask for forgiveness. Your girlfriend, your first girlfriend that was in Cape Town, if she's here, she must forgive you, because I was traveling with Godfrey, left my shoes in Godfrey's car. She found the shoes under the bed because the helper put the shoes there. She was angry, decided that I am dating Godfrey. And I hope you forgive Godfrey. I'm a sister to Godfrey, and I love him.
Wow. No, it's true.
Hello. Thank you.
It's true. You must just let it go. Eh?
Yeah. It is time to let go of other stuff. Fully agreed. At this time, we're going to call JP, Jean-Paul Ofense. And maybe before we go to Ofense and Bonginkosi, Ofense is one of the army guys at TBS, company, the Brothers Engineering Solutions, which is company, Godfrey's company. So Ofense will come through and speak about his boss, and when he's done, Bonginkosi from Bahlokwa. Bahlokwa is owned by Beginning, good friend of Tsidiso, Modupi. But colleagues, I know some of you may leave before we finish. There's baskets in front. If you feel like dropping anything cash-wise, I think we'll find a way as well to display some begging details in case one wants to...
Scorn a speed point. Speed point.
Or speed point is corner at the back. So if you feel like offering... Was about going to write, yes? Yeah, in case you want to offer, please feel free. During any time as we continue the program. JP, over to you, sir. This one does not sleep because the cities are kept him awake 24/7.
Short and sweet, colleagues.
He knows
please.
How to short defend us, this boy. Proper.
Thank you. First. Good afternoon, everyone. As they said, my name is Jean-Paul, but at the office they like calling me JP. I knew Godfrey, you know, we called him Mr. G. I knew Mr. G ever since 2022, when 2021, Dr. V called me and said, hey, my chief, my brother is opening an office in Johannesburg. Are you interested? And I was like, yes, I'm very much interested. In these past 2 years, I can say we went through a lot. There were ups and downs. There were moments where, some things were questionable. But the one thing I can say that Godfrey had was a belief in people and in himself and in God. He was able to tell you when you were going through a lot that, no, my chief, we are just there. Just this next month, 15 days, and we will be... That 15 days can be 45, by the way. But the fact that he kept it and said 15, you were motivated enough to say, no, I can push more. There were times where we, yeah, as they say, we were tendering. 2 o'clock, you're still at the office. We were like four of us, four, three. There were times where one would get tired, sleep. The rest of us would push on. Then when you get tired, the other one wakes up, we continue on. And I'm proud to say that today I am the man I am because of who he was. I'm a firstborn at home. I've never had an older brother. I've never had someone to look up to, in a sense. And he was that for me. He wasn't just my boss. He was the person that I could talk to about anything. Literally any area of my life, from academics. I've heard you guys mentioning academics, and I'm not gonna go into it. From academics to personal life, to relationships, everything that I went through, he was there to say, my chief, I'm here if you need to. And I'm proud to say that I have met one of the greatest people to live. And I'm thankful for that. There was one day, I think we learned something. I think the guys at the office can attest. Whenever he had an idea that was unorthodox, something that was out of it, he would come to you and say, you know, ne? Whenever he said that, everyone in the office knew that, no. You see, whatever he's going to say, it might work, but the risk is so high. And I'll tell you, it worked. We went to see a client who was so angry with us, so angry, to a point where you would say, nah, you know, you're thinking, how am I even going to say it? No, Godfrey gets into a meeting. It's a whole 10 people in there. All of them are looking at him like, yeah, today you are finished. And I'll tell you what, when we leave, they are exchanging contact details, they are happy. And you ask yourself, how? How can this guy do this? His ability with people is the greatest thing I know him for. His belief in people, his ability to connect is the greatest thing. I had written a poem, but just because of time, I'm just going to read a small phrase, if you allow me. Laughs we shared, troubles we carried. Time and time we persisted. Through all we smiled, through all we laughed. I think everyone can attest his laughter was infectious and it was big. Your voice a motivation, your devotion a passion, your belief a testament. Time was what we needed and time is what you gave. You gave us a chance to make you proud. Proud is what I am, proud is what I will make you. And I will make the dream come true. I will make that vision we had a reality. Because although you have passed, your legacy will always live on through me. Thank you very much.
Thanks, JP. Colleagues, in moving on, I think Usifu is tired of putting this thing up. just leaving it, yeah. I think in moving on, can I please have a corner and... Oh, Bongos, I didn't see that you're here, sir. I was moving. Colleagues, can I ask if we call your name, you both come up in the interest of time? I think the candles were scheduled for 3 hours and they're telling us that the 3 hours is almost up. So, it's fine. Thank you. After Bongos, can I please have a corner and Sakile concurrently? Thanks.
Good afternoon. I just want to add on the type of person that Mr. G was. For me, he was an embodiment of compassion and wisdom. I think even his passing attests to that. It attests to his unwavering commitment to excellence. and his relentless pursuit of success. Because if I'm not mistaken, the day he passed, I think I was on his way to the office, and I was surprised as to, because I think I was the only one in the office that day, I was surprised as to, I think it was around 11 when he wasn't there already, because the guys had already left at around 8. And when I received the news, I couldn't even imagine as to how I'm going to communicate this to the family. Just to go down memory lane, there was a day whereby Mr. G gathered his close, I think it was more than just colleagues, but then it was his friends, for a project that he wanted to go and pursue in harmony. It was a very unique project for me, as that project didn't have a scope, didn't have a bill of quantity. Basically, they had to go and build a dam, which I couldn't understand as to how, underground. And then in that dam, that project didn't have a scope, which is something that anyone can imagine as to how they were about to do that. With that said, in that boardroom, when everyone was gathered and they were discussing it, for me, I saw a vision, basically. I even asked them afterwards. I asked them as to why is it that all you guys have different companies when you guys could simply come together and create a legacy. And he said that everyone has their own passions, everyone has their own opinions, everyone has their own pursuits. So what I want to ask more than anything, since everyone is gathered here, is it possible that the differences could be left aside and we just try and focus and gather our strengths and see if maybe we can further his dream, his vision, and try and create a better future for everyone. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Akona Magongo, and I'm here to tell you how I experienced Godfrey. So please forgive me if I choke along the way. It's not the easiest way to bid farewell to a friend. I met Godfrey more than 10 years ago through Buhle. Buhle and Godfrey were younger than me. Well, they are younger than me. And I saw them as younger brothers. At home, we are three girls. So they were just the perfect brothers. This young man took a liking to me, and I would wonder to myself, what is it that they see in me? Well, the love was very much reciprocated because I loved them very much. They were young, full of life and ambition. 11 years ago, I became a professional quantity surveyor because of their consistent motivation and belief in me. They believed in me so much, and I couldn't see myself fail. Failure was just not an option. They didn't give me a choice. They would call me by my surname and say, "Aye, aye, Magongo, you have to do this. You don't have a choice." I didn't get it, but it all makes sense now from what everyone is saying. I pushed through the hardship because I was not going to embarrass myself. So I got my professional registration with their motivation, and it was a victory for all of us. That same year, we decided to register a company together. We would have regular meetings. We were young, we had big dreams, and we were very much excited about life. We struggled to think of a name. But then we decided to combine letters of our surnames, and we came up with Khonang. The G-O came from my surname, Magongo. The N-A from Manichana, and N-G from Mafeking. And the Khonang dream still lives through our dear friend, Mbuhle. Mbuhle felt that he had nothing to lose, so he took the leap of faith first. He felt that we were not all of us were going to be broke, because you know how it is when starting out a business. So our plan was to open doors for Khonang, and then when things are good, we would all join Khonang full time. But God had another plan for us. It was a plan that we didn't have for ourselves. Because of work, Godfrey had to resign as a director, and later on, I also resigned, but we continued supporting each other. Years later, I also got the itch, and I took the leap of faith, and guess who my biggest supporters were? It was the two young men that believed in me. Mbuhle was my first client, and for the longest time, and when Godfrey finally took the leap of faith, he became my client as well. That's when I got to experience Godfrey outside of Mbuhle for the very first time. Godfrey would get me so excited about potential projects because his presentation skills were so good. He knew how to pitch an idea and make you see yourself in it. He kept me motivated, looking forward to projects. There were a couple of projects that we worked together on. He would go to my office from time to time, and everyone knew when he comes, they had to close my office door because we would laugh, and everyone is correct when they say that he was loud. He was so loud, everyone would just, after he leaves, everyone would ask, who is that? Why is he so loud? You know? And Godfrey didn't like disappointing people. Whenever he didn't have the greatest news for me, you'd see it on his face. He would look down and he wouldn't give me any eye contact whatsoever, and you'd know that things are not looking good. I like the fact that he would humble himself and call me, Ati, hey, Maji, akulungi mchana, kudala ndizama. And because I knew the challenges that came with running a business, I'd end up motivating him, and we'd encourage each other to go out there, and we'd tell each other that things will get better. There was a time when he was not picking up my calls for weeks. I knew that he was tired of sounding like a broken record. He wanted to face me when he had better news for me. The day he came to see me, Mudube had dragged him to my office, and I was laughing at him because I knew that he was coming back. He was looking down, and as expected, avoiding eye contact, whilst I was bursting out in laughter as they were telling me what had happened the time that he had disappeared. I enjoyed working with GM, that's what I called him, and I'm happy to have experienced him. We spoke about a lot of things, God's plans for us, family, our big dreams, and he breathed life into me when I felt things were getting too much. We laughed about our problems and motivated each other as well. I will miss him dearly, and he will forever be in my heart. Thank you.
Ya dumela le ga ke tla le ka ba mogotswane ba no so thwena ko le yona ya reja le dikerese di atima. Good afternoon, colleagues, friends, baruti, professors, and the house at large. Ke nana ke tlo hata mo batho ba fitileng teng hobane ha ona motho buileng aska bua hantle ka Godfrey hantle lo re tsheo sa se sepi tsheo sa was very infectious mara ne se le sepi dingata ntho tseng ka buang ka tsona mara think e ke utlwileng e phetapetwa ka hara ntlo ke botho bo anana le bona botho ba hae o noka kena le Godfrey anywhere he'd be as humble as ever. But also, ukakena liena, and he'd get the job done. Harabatwa nebabuona lengaite, strating wa mutola. And he'll do just that. Itlaba mutwa strat. He'll just gel as if nothing happens. And then when you go to the boardroom, you get a different version of Godfrey. That's the kind of person that he was, multifaceted. Could incorporate and cater for everyone. And hape honale mutabuileng, Dr. Vic Murupi, Papa Blom, horo orisietzi, olisietzi, a legacy. And I think when he started this, he was not just looking for 2 years, 5 years. He was looking long term. He's done his bit. And is now it's somebody else's turn to run with what he started. And it's the beauty of it is that the vision has been engraved. JP, you can tell that the vision has been engraved. All that's left is for people to run with this vision, make it their vision. I hope you guys are ready for that.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I didn't know Ayanda could sing like that. Hey, kumnandu zekaweni. Colleagues, in proceeding with the program, I'd like to call the man that walked a long road with us, Professor Didipokuthi Twala. He's been a father, he's been a mentor, and I believe that he was Godfrey's mentor. Prof, if you may, we're not writing thesis. Let's keep it short, please. If you may, please, Prof, thank you. Prof Clint, I don't see, but we'll excuse Prof Clint. I think Prof Twala also mentored Prof Clint, so we'll speak for Prof Clint as well. Thank you, Prof.
Sanibonani. Ninjani. Hey, so I think I'm standing in front of you just on a bad day. So, but there are days that ask questions, and there are days that actually give answers. You see, I mean, when I was told about the demise of Godfrey, you know, I couldn't believe it. Because, you see, the two of them, Godfrey and Buhle, they've troubled me in my life, those two. They are troublesome. So I think I've learned a lot from them, and I also think they've learned a lot from me. So I met them so at the university while they were still doing their undergraduate. So we had that kind of relationship in terms of lecturer-student actual relationship. So then Godfrey was the most organized guy. And then we've got the other side, which is Buhle. Even now, very troublesome. I always fight with him in terms of that. So, but I think it also shows us. I always talk to people about that, to say, here are two different characters. They come together. When they come together, they make something happen. So they may be, because the other one was well organized, the other one is still alive, is a well disorganized fellow. So, but one thing that I've learned in my period from the time when they were students, they were able to deliver, the two of them. If you give them a task, they will deliver. They went to the company site, at work they were working, even at work they were delivering. They are running their own companies. If you give them work, actually they are able to deliver. So we actually move on in terms of undergraduate. We move in terms of masters. I supervise them, so in their master's program. So, and then they finish, so under me. So that relationship after that, it developed into another relationship because I continued, so just to mentor them now, so in terms of their workplace. I remember when Godfrey got his first job, you know, there are these particular checks which they were doing now. You need to do a reference. You write those particular things. Godfrey say one thing. He say, look here. He used to call me, actual prof, my prof. He say, look here. In the reference that you must write, just put something and say, if ever Godfrey is not employed, this company won't make profit. So please put that one. I say, Godfrey, how am I going to put that particular thing this? So I say, no, Godfrey, unless they call me. If they can't call me, then, so when we're discussing, then I can tell the person then who's calling me. But they say, no, it must be there in the reference. I say, Godfrey, no, man, it can't. So he was trying just in terms of convincing me to say, actually, how good, I mean, he was. So then they used to invite me into games. So I watched some rugby games. We used to be there. You know, they used to be troublesome there. So, but I need just to call them into order. So we had some good moments with them. So in those particular things. So I think there was one particular thing that we always remember Godfrey in terms of support. So I think as the program director was talking about the issue of Swaziland, they went to Swaziland, I was not invited. On the issues, there are issues where I was invited, there are functions where I was not invited. I don't know on the other activities why I was not invited, like the Swaziland one. I don't know what happened in Swaziland, but I was not invited there. I was told after the function had happened in Swaziland, hey, they were in Swaziland. So by mistake, Godfrey used to tell me everything. So, I mean. So, but one thing happened at Campus Square, which I think is part of a highlight because we're talking about the life of Godfrey. So, celebrating the life of Godfrey. So, I went there with Buhle. Godfrey was at home. So, I think he was just tired or he was just flying somewhere the following day. And then, Buhle almost died at Campus Square. So, we're together. So, I was going to be responsible myself. So, why is a former student now? We are mentoring Godfrey. I mean, Buhle now. Buhle almost died now. So what happened there? We're in one restaurant. Yeah, I don't remember the restaurant, but one restaurant in Campus Square. Oh, I think it was Dross. I remember very well, it was Dross. So what happened? When we're sitting there, I think it was around 9 at night, before they close. And then I saw Godfrey now, I mean, Buhle now. He was not well now. You know, the way he was breathing, not breathing very well, no, he was showing some signs, some difficult signs now. I say, really? What's happening here? On when I was looking around now, hey, I found things were not good, man. So before he got married, So actually the girlfriend was there who was with another man. So here's the story now. I took a call. I take my phone now. I call Godfrey now. Godfrey, hey, there's a problem. I'm encountering a problem, you know. How should I? Godfrey just laughed at me, laugh. He say, no, I think the two men have done a good thing to the comrades. So actually, that was the answer from Godfrey's side. That's how Godfrey, I mean, he was actually behaving. So what happened now? We had those packer thing. So we had some moment. I think in terms of last day, we had a 4-hour meeting, so with Godfrey. So because normally, I meet the two of them, but it happens sometimes. I wanted to meet the two of them, but it was difficult because Buhle would always disappear. So the two of them, even when they were still students doing their masters, if they've not done their work, the two of them would switch off their phone, and then, they actually disappear. So until after some time, I'll find them maybe after 2 weeks, once they've done my work. So that's the kind of the pickup people. So in the 4-hour meeting with Godfrey, we discuss a lot of things. So I think myself, I've got an understanding in terms of Godfrey, in terms of a life, academic side, company side, also in terms of a life in general. There are things that we used to discuss with Godfrey. When Godfrey was having some challenges, he actually used to call me. And then another thing, when he called you, Godfrey, he have got something, a challenge that he need to talk to you about. He will say, he will force you to make time for him. He will say, no problem, we can even meet at 9 at night or 10 at night. So Godfrey was that particular person who was so persuasive, so in terms of things, if ever there was something that you need to do. So we discussed so many things. He shared last year, I think it was around the 4th of October, where you had a four-hour meeting, we're just sitting in a restaurant for those. She shared so many things about his vision and also the other things, you know, which maybe sometimes they were not going well. So then I come with some solution to say, how can we deal actually with those particular things? But in those particular decision, he was also a jokey person. I remember the particular meeting, he just told me to say, look here, I must get a second wife. He said, you have already identified that wife, and what you have done, he will pay lobola for me. So that's why I'm standing here. I'm worried about the lobola now. They say he's going to pay for me for the second wife. Now coffee is not on that. So that's the kind. He used to talk something, you know, in terms of more serious things, and also in that particular thing, he also brings some other things in terms of that. So myself, in fact, I left for East London. So in January, HLF asked me, I have to go to WSU. They just head in terms of the engineering faculty, just to bring together just four faculties together, just to make it one. So I didn't tell Godfrey that I was going there. I remember I called Godfrey on the 15th of January. I say, Godfrey, hey man, I'm in East London now. I'm going to work in East London now. He say, East London? I say, yes. The first thing he say to me, oh, Prof, be careful of the Xhosa girls. They are problematic, especially the one in East London. Please be careful. I say, Godfrey, I'm going here to work. So I say, you are not even asking me about my work that I'm going to do now. You are just telling me about the Xhosa women of East. Say, those one of East London. Yeah, they're very, very problematic. Yeah, you must be careful about. So then I say, no, what you need to do, you must come here. So that, we can be able just to look at other things. I think on the 7th of March, this year now, they went, that's the kind of people they are, Buhle and Godfrey, what they are. They called me on the 7th, I think 7 or 8, it's on the 7th. Now they say, hey, we're boarding a flight. I say, boarding a flight? I say, where are you? Say, OOR, where are you going to? We're coming to East London. I say, but why didn't you tell me? Because myself, I've got a meeting in Cape Town, 7, 8, 9. I'm not going to run. They say, no, we're just going to have a meeting, so with a client, potential client in East London. So myself, we actually didn't meet, so because they were there just for one night, and then the previous day, I mean the following dates, they actually came to Johannesburg. So after that, I had to call them, we had to discuss with Buhle, just some few things. Buhle say he was building some school that site, so he say he's going to come back. He went to East London, Buhle, he say he will call, he never called. So again, so in terms of Godfrey now, we had to call Godfrey. I think we had to talk with Godfrey. I think it was on the 10th, 10th of March, that look here, because we have not met on the East London when they came to East London. So we're going to meet during these Easter holidays because I'll be coming to Joburg and then I'll be going home. Then when I come back from home, so we're going to discuss. So in terms of other issues and also in terms of other opportunities, because I think there are other opportunities which are actually there, which I've been involved, so I'll share with them. So, but only to get a call to say, look here, Godfrey is actually no more. So, but I think one of the particular lesson, I mean, I can talk about Godfrey because I think I've engaged Godfrey just for many years. I understand some other issues. So, but I think one of the things that maybe I think we should have done. You see, sometimes as a child, you can talk to a child to say, do 1, 2, 3. When sometimes a child is not doing that, sometimes you need to force the child to do something. So I'm just saying, there are things that in life you can prevent. You don't need prayer all the time. If a person is hungry, you can't pray for a person to be full. But you can say, can you God, you pray to say, God, can you give me just more power, more energy to be able to do 1, 2, 3 in terms of work. So in hunger, you can't pray for a hungry person. The person is hungry. You need to give the person food. So I still believe as friends, maybe there are more things we're supposed to do. But that one is a past tense. But I think to me, Godfrey is giving us a particular lesson in life to say, when there are things which are there, sometimes we need to be able just to say, let us do this particular thing to save a particular situation. Sometimes prayer is not the only thing, but action sometimes is something that you need to do. So in those particular few words, so they asked me to talk, but really, I was not comfortable in terms because I think I was not well. I'm still not well in terms of just to comprehend, to say Godfrey is gone. But however, one particular thing that we're sure about, Godfrey was born, as they say, 1987. But today, one thing that we're definitely sure about, that Godfrey is no more. When they call me, I just say, look here, when they say Godfrey have passed on, I say, I don't believe it. Maybe Godfrey have just disappeared with Buhle because they used to disappear from me. So, whereas this time it was a reality that in terms of Godfrey is no more. So, yeah. May his soul rest in peace and all family members just be comforted. All of us will be with you. So, yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Prof. Asimzame ukukhona ngezandla esehla. Good people, at this time, let us allow the pastor to come to the podium. We've reached the end of our program. Now it's time for the word of God. And we'll ask Brother Opa to give us a song. After that, the voice that you will hear, Gimaki, will do then the vote of thanks and we'll be done with our program. But please, before we leave, there's some finger lunch prepared at the back. Please grab something on your way out. Thank you so much. We really appreciate you coming to celebrate the life. That's it.
Thank you, sir.
Joki muso lo solo haki karato lelikalo
Are we good now? Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, amen. To the bereaved family, the Mufugeng family, to the next of kin, the children, the colleagues at work, business partners, friends, relatives, we really want to extend our acknowledgement to you as we also extend our condolences in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Recognizing also the ministers of the gospel of Jesus Christ, irrespective of which denomination they may be drawn from, we are so thankful that you could join us today to be here at this memorial service. Your presence is always divine, and we do not take it for granted, and we give glory to God for your being present here in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Let me begin by saying to the family that we are deeply sorry for your loss. No one person is ever ready for the departure of another, especially those that are close to our hearts. We may extend tributes and even condolences, at times even pretend to understand and bear the pain with you, but you know it deeper, for you have known the person much closer than we do. But do draw solace from this illustration I'm going to make. One time, Colin Powell, at the time Joint Chief of Staff of the war and the army that was invading Saddam Hussein's Iraq in what was popularly known as the Gulf War. So Colin Powell is called upon by the officers in charge on the ground to come and see wounded soldiers. Some had left their wives and their kids with full limbs. And in battle, they had been wounded. And as they got wounded, some lost their limbs, some lost their legs, some lost their arms, some lost their eyes, and etc. He flies from the United States of America, his home country, to come and see them in preparation for them before they depart back to their home soil. And the hall is organized and they are full in the hall. And the officer in charge goes and collects Colin Powell and he ushers him into the room. And Colin Powell goes to each and every one of them and gives them a solid handshake. And he says to them, "Well done. America is proud of you." And he moves to the next, does the same thing until he finishes. As they expect him to ascend to the podium, he goes and leaves the room. And the officer in charge rushes after him to go and stop him, for he then assumes he forgot to do what he came for, which is to make a speech that would make them understand how he, as the Joint Chief of Staff seconded by America, is sorry for their loss
And he says, Chief, you left without making a speech. These people are expecting you to extend your condolences. Not only that, but to say how sorry you are. Irritated, Colin Powell turns back to the officer in charge and says, how dare you? How dare you, you make me demean this man's courage? They fought a worthy battle, a worthy cause in their eyes, and were injured on duty, exercising their purpose. How then dare you ask me to lower their dignity by saying that what they died in battle to execute, they could not have anticipated? I will not demean them that way. What am I saying this morning? I'm saying to you as a family, every one of us has a purpose to achieve in life. And it seems to me as I listened throughout the tributes, and I was fortunate to listen almost to all of them, the one thing that is a shining bright example about this gentleman we are paying tribute to is how he led a purposeful life and led as a shining light the adventures to certain areas of life. And led many of you in your respective companies and associates to understand that there's a bigger picture to be achieved. And there is a way in which we can do so, irrespective of what the cost is. And if I understand well, he met his death at the execution of his purpose. How then dare, do you ask me, to belittle a man who fell at the time of execution of his purpose? Instead, let me say to you, we must congratulate him for being faithful till the last hour. Let me close by saying, because I'm not going to be long, there's a verse that many of you in the Bible, less than matured by religious fanatics like I, that he came and said a few words but said nothing about the word of God that we expected him to say. There is a word. It's a word that all of you, I have no doubt, know. The very first verse you come across in the Bible. And it is in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. It says, in the beginning, God made the heavens and the earth. Full stop. That's it. What does it say? In the beginning, God made heavens and earth. I just want to speak about that for a couple of minutes and then we pray. And I know theologians must be at pain with me as what is he really going to say about that verse, whoever preaches about that verse. It's not an easy one. But let me tell you, if there is a beginning, then it must mean that there is an end. Where are we right now? Are we at the beginning or are we the end? Let's start from the known to the unknown. In 1924, if I'm not mistaken, George Lemaître invents the theory of the Big Bang that science is widely accepted to be true. And allow me to repeat what you already know. The theory simply suggests that there is a tiny particle that was suddenly overcame with highest form of density and a lot of heat in it. Tiny, tiny particle. High sense of density. And it exploded to a fireball into space. As it exploded to fireplace into space, it began to grow bigger and bigger into smaller and smaller particles, which in turn grew bigger and bigger, and they form what we know today as the universe. All the planets, all the galaxies, the stars, the sun, the moon, the billions and billions of galaxies, many of which are still today, as a matter of fact, it is accepted by science that the world, or at least the universe, continues to expand at this very moment as we are here. And they seem to suggest that they measure that back to 13.8 billion years ago. So it appears to me that in 1924, you can do your measurement of calculations. An invention is made by a guy called George Lemaître, who says that this is how it started. But whatever theory you follow in terms of the formation or the start of the universe or the beginning of life, as we may call it, we then accept that. That one is the widely accepted by science. What no theory of science or any other kind has been able to answer is to who had placed the particle there. Number two, what may have caused the high density there? Now, it begins to challenge, of course, you know about the law of causation, that nothing moves unless a force moves it forward. Everything must stay where it is. There is a cause that arises with an effect. There is no effect without a cause. Now, that's a law of causation. The law of inertia tells us the following. Everything stays static unless pushed forward by a force to move. Everything stays moving unless stopped by a repelling force. We're talking science a little bit. Now the next question is, what caused the particle in terms of the law of causation to have the effect of explosion? What caused the particle to move into space in terms of the law of inertia? Now, science cannot negate these theories and accept us to relax as if nothing has happened. Then we accept that with the best of motives, science is unable to explain the particle and the causation that led to the effect and the inertia laws. And I forgive science and all the noble people that have discovered what they thought they could discover. And there's a simple reason for it. Because science, my definition, John Nevecha, I know the definition that is conventionally accepted, is nothing more than discovery of what always was there but was unknown to man. In other words, science does not have the power to create. Science does not have the power really to invent. Science has the power to discover. Let me make the point more poignantly. A prism glass transmits the same rays of the sun that you and I are looking at now, and transmits that same rays of sun and produces seven colors of the rainbow the other side. Nothing new has happened, only that we have put in an object that is not able to transmit this and show us that it is not what you see it for. It is actually seven colors of the rainbow the other side. Now, it takes one to discover that by accident most of the time and then invent it into something. So I am not against science. I am for science. But science discovers all what has always been there, doesn't invent anything. What does this verse we read say? In the beginning, God created. Now the word created in its original context simply means that out of nothing utters he words that form something. If I had time, I'd take you to the science of that. Out of nothing utters he words that form something. What is the first thing he says in verse 3? Let there be light. What does science discover? The light as it explodes. But it does not discover what happened before the light was there. There was a causation
that gave effect, and that causation was God Almighty, Elohim, Jehovah, able to utter words to say into nothing, let there be light. And there was light. The first thing the Bible records as is created is light. So science, hopefully, at some point will discover this too. The difference between God and what science offers us is that God cannot be discovered. God reveals himself. Now, you must mark that distinction. Because if you are going to go to a laboratory and attempt to discover God, you are going to try until the cows come home and find no answer. But when God deems it the right time in his sovereign diary of divinity, he reveals himself like he is to somebody tonight. Right as I speak, you are beginning to get the revelation. What is a revelation? A revelation, and I want to give you a verse, and my pianist can come because in 2 minutes I'm done. A revelation is as follows. Revelation chapter 14, verse 13 gives us this. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, blessed are those who die in the Lord. Actually, let me quote it properly. Blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors and their works do follow them. Now, revelation simply means, and I'm going to again do it by illustration, suppose that this canvas at my back was a big window and this was a curtain. You would never tell what is behind me unless I draw the curtain open. When I draw the curtain open, then you see there's a big tree behind me. But the big tree always was there. So when I'm talking revelation, I am not introducing something new. I'm simply saying, open the curtain so I may see across. So that's what revelation means. Now, John, who writes Revelations, is the last surviving disciple in the inner circle of three, if you like, you can say of 12 of Jesus Christ, one of the first 12 apostles. He lived the longest until he was in his 90s. He is the only one that history records to have died a natural death. Legend has it, and let's define legend. Legend is a popularly accepted story about a historical event that was never authenticated. So you got the disclaimer there. But here's what they say about John, which they accept to be true historically. In the pursuit against the Christians of the first century church, who dared to have the conviction that Jesus Christ died and rose again 3 days later, as we were celebrating the Passover recently. As a result, they believed in him as the only Lord. Not even the tyranny of the current administration or Roman emperors was able to substitute their belief. They were prepared to die for that belief than to have it substituted by conditions that were adverse to them. And one emperor called Nero notably was the most notorious and wicked. He burnt alive anyone that was found to be professing Jesus as Lord. And there was a search for them so that they could kill this thing called Christianity. And in that search, they knew that there was a remnant in the inner circle of Jesus Christ called John. And when they arrested John for the profession of his belief in Jesus Christ as the only Lord and as the only God and one who was superior even to Nero and his successive emperors, they asked him a potent question. They put a drum and they boiled it to boiling point with oil. And they looked at John and I asked the question, now you tell us, who is Lord? And John was not unsmart not to understand the consequences of his answer. If I say Jesus is Lord and hold on to my profession and conviction and faith, I'm jumping into this boiling oil without even having to ask for it. And the consequence is that if I'm not badly injured beyond recognition, the reality is that I may as well die. And then John begins to assemble himself to answer the questions, and I allow me to imagine as he considers his position. He looks at the boiling water, and he sees the danger associated with that. And then he looks at eternity, and he measures which is more potent than the other. And he then concludes, boiling oil, I may be dipped into you. And I may, after hours, die if not suffer so much injury that I'll be taken to hospital. Perhaps after a month, I'll be no more. But when I die, I must go and meet the same Jesus I would have denied. And he lives in eternity. He was there at the beginning. He will be there at the end. He is without beginning and without end. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Therefore, I must ponder my answer carefully. What is my answer going to be? I saw him walk on water and defying the laws of gravity. I saw him touch a contagious person that was having leprosy. Instead of being also getting this leprosy, he healed him and he remained also clean. I saw him feed 5,000 men, excluding women and children. It should ordinarily account for about 15,000 people at one go with 2 fish and 5 bread. I saw him transfigured on the mountain and take the glory as if the lightning was all over him. And he called into the present and past General Elijah and Moses. I know him because I saw him. I was at the foot of the cross when they nailed him and he said, it is finished. I saw him as we wept, believing that it is all gone. But I saw him on Sunday morning when he rose from the dead. And I was there when the angels asked the question, why are you looking for the alive amongst the dead? I walked with him and saw him in the city for 40 days. I was there when Thomas, the doubting Thomas, asked to pierce his fingers through his nails, or at least his wounds, to establish it was the same Jesus Christ. So I have seen empirical evidence of his supernatural nature. Therefore, even death, or even injury, even if it is at the point of boiling oil, I will suffer. For when I measure the extent of my pain, in this pain I'm about to get, it is like a drop in an ocean compared to the longevity of eternity. Then it says, Jesus is Lord. To their amazement, he dared them. He had the audacity to dare them. They took him, legend goes, and dropped into the drum, and they pulled him out, and John came out as if nothing had happened to him. Because when Jesus is with you, he walks with you even through the fires. And those that had set up this trap in order to make sure that John says no to his master and denies him, They were the first to go and testify about the great miracle they saw. When they had planned to make John become the one that falters on the last hour, that plan of evil turned to be good. What was the good? They were the first to be saved. They were the first to receive the Jesus. They told many about the miracle, and the whole city came to want to know more about this Jesus because he was in the beginning. And you know what they did? Tyrannies, like all do, even today. They picked him up and they threw him into a similar like of Robben Island called the Island of Patmos. Lento le solitary confinement ay kalinge Robben Island. Island of Patmos in Greek times. And there he writes what he's writing. I heard a voice from heaven and it said to me, write these things. And he went down to write in honor of the word from heaven. He says, blessed are those who die in the Lord from henceforth. For all their labors and pain they are rested from. And all their works shall follow them. The word blessed simply means joyful. The word blessed simply means happy. The word blessed simply means that I am in awe of how grateful I am. I've heard a testimony on one too many speakers today about the fact that this brother of ours that we are commending and paying tribute had committed his life to Jesus Christ. And I'm here to make the final announcement in case you missed it. Blessed is Godfrey Mufugeng, who has died in the Lord. From henceforth, he is rested from every... He has no headache to prepare for a board meeting, let me tell you. There is no headache that he must face about how to untangle a difficult moment with clients that are difficult. He doesn't have a challenge about asking himself, how will I make sure that my school fees for my kids in varsity are done? He doesn't have a problem about making sure that a wife that could be deemed nagging, and I know his one did not nag, is sorted. He does not have a problem about thinking about what to contend with whatever you and I are contending with. Why? Because all his labors he's rested from. He does not have a problem with pain that you and I must face. As a matter of fact, may I suggest to you, if you could, unfortunately you can't, go and invite him back to life. He said, no, thank you, it's too good where I am. Blessed are those who die in the Lord from henceforth, and their works shall follow them. In other words, there's a great judge upon whom we're going to answer for everything we've done this kind of the world. The only trouble here is that the medium to eternity through God with peace is through the same man crucified called Jesus Christ. And he took that conscious decision. Quite apart from the adventures into commerce that he made, quite apart from the great strides he made in industry, quite apart from the great strides he made in family structure and businesses, he made a good choice. Before he died, he committed himself to Jesus Christ. And I want to say to us this afternoon, if ever there is something that we can draw leaf from his life, we can be able to say, we want also to make sure that our future is guaranteed into eternity. Many a times we mistake ministry of the word of God, thanks to us as ministers who are erratic, as an invitation to join churches or denominations. In fact, any minister, in my view, that does that, and I say this with humility, is extremely naive. Because the reconciliation of ministry of Jesus Christ is between God and man. Churches and denominations are actually a human invention. When you go to heaven, once you die, they don't ask you come from the Assemblies of God or not. Do you come from the Roman Catholic Church or not? They ask one key question. Did you receive Christ Jesus as your Lord and Savior? That's your ticket to eternity in heaven. What am I saying to you tonight? We have a duty, and this is batting a sposo unendlebenje unetyala. I don't know how to interpret that contextually, but once you've heard, you have a problem because you are going to, I can tell you, you are not going to rest in your mind until you do something about what I told you today, if you are hearing it for the first time. If you've heard it before and you did nothing, it's a revival in your soul that says, if Godfrey did it, why can I not do it? And all we are asking you to do, pay tribute to this man. Take leave from his book. And get this Jesus that guarantees life in eternity in peace. Take this Jesus that is able to get you a blessing even in death. What a dichotomy. A blessing in death. It means that the opposite is true. The contrary is true. There are those that are cursed in death. But this one is blessed in death. May God bless you. Let us pray. If we can bow our heads, sit down, it's okay. I know our churches normally like people to stand, and mine is the first to do so. If we just bow our heads, close our eyes, I really want to pray with you. I do think it's a divine appointment orchestrated under the guise of a memorial service. Someone here is saying, Mfundis, pray with me a prayer that connects me with this Jesus by faith. And I want to make sure that if I do die, I don't miss the mark of eternity with him. As a matter of fact, my life is likely to be more purposeful with him in mind. And if you want me to join you in that prayer, just hold. Put your hands where your heart beats. And I will be more than privileged to say a prayer for you that connects you with your God and he reconciles you. Just a touch on your heart. I see the hand. God sees the heart. I can see my brother that hand. I can see my sister that hand. I see those hands. This is not a matter of a religious preference. This is a matter of connection, reconciliation between man and God, woman and God. I see those hands in the name of Jesus and I bless you, man. Let me say this prayer and I ask you to say it after me. Let's help them. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I do acknowledge and believe that you were born by the Virgin Mary, died on the cross, and raised again after 3 days. Seated now on the right-hand side of God in heavenly places. I pray that you cleanse all my sins and write off all my transgressions through your blood that was spilled on the cross in Jesus' mighty name. Write my name now on the book of life that if I die, I may be with you in eternity. Bless me. Remove all curses that I may have had, generationally or otherwise, and usher to me my blessings of today, going forward in Jesus' mighty name. And I pray that now I declare, I am a new creature in Christ Jesus, to the glory of God. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Find a church if you don't have one that preaches the word of God in its purity. No gimmicks. Find a church. There are many. And if you don't have one, our doors are always open. But find a church. There are many closer to where you are. Read one verse a day if you can from this very book of John. Pray if you can at least 3 times a day. And you will see your growth in matters of faith. There is nothing impossible with God. God bless you.
Namuso. Good afternoon, everyone. Ha ke le dumedise bohle le bitsong le letle la morena Jesu Kriste. Moloki wa rona. My name is Kinalemang Matlakwane, aka Maki, Antiza to many of Sidiso's friends and associates. Ke eme mo ke le mangwane wa Tshidiso, but who happened to be his mother from day one, since day one, from 1st of July 1987, I was there at the hospital. It's just that at that time, Nesoka Reba enlightened or we can join them in the labor room. But Tshidiso has touched so many lives. And with a very heavy heart, I'm very much comforted to realize and to learn that most of these people who are gathered here, I have known them for so many years. Tshidiso was blessed to be a blessing into other people's lives. I was requested to come and give a vote of thanks. First and foremost, let me thank you for gracing us with your presence to celebrate the life of Tshidiso Godfrey Molefi Mofokeng. He was a wonderful human being, a man who touched many lives with his kindness, generosity, and a very loud and somewhat embarrassingly humor. The man could laugh out loud, no matter. And he could burst into laughter, no matter what, unapologetically so. So on that note, I would like to say, Tshidiso, with your humor and with your charisma, thank you, Wanak. He's poor. Where is he now? You are a clown, too. You are a clown. Look, Tshidiso was my best friend. I'm not here to give a speech, but I would like to take this opportunity to say he was my partner in so many good and somewhat stupid things or stupid dreams. And I'm going to miss him dearly. I miss him already, but I know that he's in a better place. On that note, I would like to thank Pastor Matlodi and Apostle Mqebesha for their comforting words and prayers. I would also like to thank our program directors, Obo Butiza, Buhle and Sivu. They are also my sons. However, sometimes they bring me to their level. Gentlemen, thank you for your selflessness, professionalism, and compassion during this difficult time. You guys made everything easier for us as a family during and beyond. I would also like to thank our DJ, I didn't take his name, for your beautiful songs that uplifted our spirits. Thank you so much. Also, I would like to thank the friends who are now part of the family. Leskela rilahla, halina chance. I would also like to thank business associates, the colleagues, and everyone for your presence, support, and contributions to make this gathering a befitting experience and event. Your presence added meaning to this wonderful service. From the bottom of our hearts, we thank you. On a personal note, where is Prof? I would like to thank Prof Twala. You must thank Tshidiso. Prof, my Prof. Tshidiso touched so many lives, and he left us with a legacy. And one of the most important things that I would like to take, the reason why I'm singling out Prof is because we ended up becoming friends. Are we friends?
And I ended up becoming his mentor, parenting-wise. I'm now his mentor, yes. He comes, he calls me to say, Kena, what do you do when your child wants to go to university? What do you do, this and that, and so forth? And yes, Prof, thank you for holding my nephew's hand from the beginning until the end. You provided him with your exceptional knowledge, and through your selflessness, you afforded him the opportunity to pass his master's degree with cum laude. As we speak right now, I'm almost there and the standard has been set. Thank you so much, Prof. I would also like to thank all of you who reached out to us as a family. Your sympathy messages, phone calls, flowers, and donations. Your kindness and generosity have been overwhelming and helped us cope with our sudden loss. I'm truly grateful for your friendship and support. Lastly, I would like to thank Abut. I used to call him Abut. Mwanaka, thank you for your unconditional love and unwavering support. Zbosh, I was told that I've got a twin somewhere, but he never wanted us to meet. And he always wanted to explain, but he never got to a point of explaining. And with Sidiso, there was no window of or any opportunity of failure. Even if you can see, you could see that mona ona chance, aria maki, get I salt out, get I fry. And onana libu kirikirinyana bahai. Na onana na lo rotla dribula. And let me tell you, I don't remember Sidiso coming back to say to me, I can't. He also taught me that, Maki, if you don't know something, don't say you can't. He would either call Buhle, he would either call Sivu, he'd bo akhona. Everyone in his circle, he would always tell me that someone would have like a solution. And on that note, as we celebrated his life so wonderfully today, and we are about to say our last goodbyes to Chidiso this coming Saturday, may we kindly remember his legacy of love, generosity, selflessness, and excellence. But more than anything, his faith. Chidiso was a prayerful man. Unatiba mudimu. Ausi waka utamaile nze msebeti wa muhulu wa uruta banaba hai hurapela. And that was a treasure that I wish each and every one of us could bestow or engrave in our children at a very tender age. Sidiso would have wanted us to live our lives fully and happily, knowing that he is watching over us from heaven. As he would always say to me, Maki, don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. Fare thee well, my gentle giant. Tsela tshwe uphoka. Robala ka kagiso setlogolo sa batlong. Goodbye, daddy wa banana. Rest easy, abuti wa bana baka. Adios, my companero. May your spirit live longer. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Colleagues, thank you. I think we have finally reached the end of our program. I'd like to ask Pastor Sivu to please just close for us in a word of prayer so that we can officially close off. Thank you.
If we may stand to our feet, please, and as we close, Just remember that as you leave, grab something at the back so that you can munch on your way home. Thank you so much. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this day that we have gathered here to celebrate our brother Godfrey. We pray your blessing, O God, to each and every family represented here right now. In the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for every broken heart. Heal us, O God, have compassion on us. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord, we pray that his legacy will live on. Help us, O God, to stand firm and to support him and to support his family. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we thank you, Lord. Lord, I speak a blessing to each and every one of us as we leave. Guide us, O God, and protect us. Keep us safe, Lord, and our loved ones. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.